I welcome all of you on Yourpedia Education, and as you know, Yourpedia has come out with this tailor-made HPCL module, and HPCL exam is declared now, that is on 11th and 12th of August 2021. Now, as you know, we are coming out with a series of questions, most expected questions. So the questions which I am going to discuss with you today, they are from industrial engineering. I will be covering more than 100 questions. And similar to that, for each topic, we are going to cover 100 plus questions for your better preparation. So invest 2-3 hours with us and get entire feel of entire subject within very less time, and that will help you for revision. Now only 12 days are left. This is the best strategy for revision of any subject. You know, these questions have been taken from previous year's public sector exams only. The kind of questions asked in BHEL and maybe HPCL exams and different state exams, so they are taken from there. Another reference of questions is objective questions, one mark question, which are asked normally in GATE and engineering services exams. So it's a combination of all those questions. So mentors have done some kind of analysis and giving you these questions. So revise this question with us and revise thousands of questions before you go for exam. So let us start with this first topic, and first topic is of industrial engineering. And we will be covering in this industrial engineering the miscellaneous topics. That means we will be covering all the topics in a particular time period, so that entire subject could be revised for us. Okay, so let us go for now these questions. What do we mean by break even point, sale and total cost? So let me now tell you break even ka thoda sa concept hota kya hai break even. See, break-even point ye hota hai when total cost and total revenue is equal. Suppose this side I give you the quantity and this side I give you the cost. Then you know we have two kind of cost. We have a cost which is called fixed cost, and we have a cost which is called variable cost. If I add variable cost on fixed cost only, this one was fixed cost, this one was variable cost. And this becomes total cost. So what is total cost? Is the fixed cost plus variable cost. As you know, fixed cost is, example is something like rent. Rent of the building is a fixed cost. Variable cost is something like a material cost. You know, the material given to a person. Let me give you the example of educational institute. Rent of this building is a fixed cost. But material given to a student depends upon how many students register in this particular course. So that is a material cost, is variable cost. When we add this, it becomes total cost. And you know, this total cost is calculated as total cost is fixed cost plus variable cost. And why I am multiplying it with Q? Because fixed cost is calculated in rupees, but variable cost is calculated in rupees per unit. That is the variable cost, and this is the quantity. So if you see dimensionally, this total cost is in rupee. So fixed cost 50,000 plus variable cost rupees 10 per unit and 10 units. So something like that is the total cost. Now other than total cost, there is something which we basically call as the revenue. You know, this is the sale. Sale or revenue. What is the sale or revenue? Now sale is nothing but or total revenue, if I write it as sale, that is nothing but S into Q. Now what is S? S is the selling price per unit. This is defined as the selling price per unit, and number of unit is Q. Now there will be a point at which the sale and your total cost will be matched, and at that place you get break-even point. So at that point you have neither profit nor loss. So if you basically have a production more than Q, then you get profit, and if your production is less than Q, then you get the loss. But at this point, break-even point, your sale revenue is equal to total cost. This SQ is equal to, if I say sale revenue is equal to total cost, and that helps you to calculate the value of break-even point. And this Q star can be then calculated as, if you see, this F over S minus V. Remember that S is more than variable cost per unit. So, S value of S is more than value of V. How do you calculate S? Rupees per unit. How do you calculate V? Rupees per unit. And how do you calculate F? That is rupees. So, I hope you have understood this. So, break even is the point at which there is neither profit nor loss. If you produce more than break even, you get the profit. If you produce less than break even, you get the loss. So, this was break even point, neither profit nor you are getting any kind of loss. And if the exam mein question comes, break even point ko aap kaise define karte hain, to isko do tarike se define kar sakte hain, in terms of number of units q star, or you can also calculate it in the basically in terms of total turnover, and that turnover can be q star into s in terms of rupees. Turnovers is in rupees. That means I will say when I do the work, when I do the business of 1 lakh, I hit my break even. That means I am neither getting profit nor loss. Now suppose I doing business, if I start doing business more than 1 lakh, then I get profit. So if I don't do business of 1 lakh, I end up doing losses. That is the meaning of it. Let us go to next question. Break even point indicates the recovery of what? You know, in the beginning, you invest the money in the beginning, you do not have customer. So, aap apni jeb se paisa lagate ho. Break even tak aate aate kya hota hai ki jitna tum paisa laga rahe ho, utna revenue bhi aa raha hai. To tumhara recover ho raha hai, total cost recover ho rahi hai. Not only fixed cost, but variable cost bhi recover ho rahi hai. So, to answer this question, both fixed and variable cost are recovered. So, again, if I give you the diagram, so suppose this is the value of number of units and this is the cost. So, as I told you that if you have this as the total cost, jab maine total cost bola, that is fixed cost plus variable cost, and we have, you see, this is the total revenue. So, this is the revenue. So, kya hota hai? At break even point, Q star is break even point. So, break even point ke upar jitna mere paas revenue aa raha hai और जितना मैंने टोटल कॉस्ट किया वो रिकवर हो रही है. अब इससे ऊपर अगर मैं प्रोडक्शन करूंगा, तो मेरे पास प्रॉफिट हो जाएगा. सो इफ आई डू प्रोडक्शन मोर देन दिस आई हैव प्रॉफिट, अदरवाइज आई एंड अप डूइंग लॉस. सो ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट का लॉजिक इज दिस. सो विच एक्चुअली कॉस्ट इज रिकवर्ड, बोथ फिक्स कॉस्ट एज वेल एज बोथ वेरिएबल कॉस्ट आर recovered. That is the meaning of it, right? So this is how we have to understand it. Now there is a graphical device which is used to basically find out the break even point and profit potential under different conditions of output and cost. Uska naam hai break even chart. Yaad rakhna, break even chart kisko bolte hain. Aur kyunki yahan pe aur bhi chart de rakhe hain, ab inka meaning kya hota hai? गैंट चार्ट क्या होता है? गैंट चार्ट तुम्हारा परफॉर्मेंस शो करता है विद द टाइम. ये टाइम है इस तरफ और यहाँ पे तुम्हारी एक्टिविटीज होती हैं और तुम बताते जाते हो कि कौन सी एक्टिविटीज किस टाइम के साथ साथ तुम्हारी हो रही है. लेट अस से दिस इज एक्टिविटी ए, दिस इज एक्टिविटी बी, दिस इज एक्टिविटी सी. सो ऑल दीज आर एक्टिविटीज. सो यू विल कीप ऑन सेइंग टाइम के साथ साथ इतनी एक्टिविटीज कंप्लीट हो जा रही हैं. सो लेट अस से I talk about month of August. तो भाई अगस्त में कौन कौन सी activities हो चुकी हैं, तो मैं बोलूँगा सर activities C activity इतना हो गया है, B activity complete हो गया है और A activity अभी इतना हुआ है. That is called Gantt chart. So somebody asks you what is Gantt chart? तो आप बोलेंगे सर Gantt chart जो है वो activity की performance बताता है आपका time के साथ कि कितना activity complete हो चुका है. Somebody asks you what is PERT? PERT is the network diagram. You know, PERT is nothing but PERT is the network diagram. So there are some kind of activities shown on the network. Activity A, B, C, D, node 1, 2, 3, 4. This is PERT and CPM. PERT and CPM hota kya hai? Sir, wo network diagram hota hai. These are network diagrams. ये कहाँ यूज़ होते हैं? सर ये प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट के अंदर यूज़ होते हैं. प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट टूल्स होते हैं। ये प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट के कौन से फेज में यूज होते हैं पर्ट एंड सीपीएम? सारे फेज में, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम योर प्लानिंग, एग्जीक्यूशन, इंप्लीमेंटेशन, फॉलो अप, ऑल द स्टेजेस यू यूज पर्ट एंड सीपीएम एज नेटवर्क डायग्राम्स। ओके, व्हाट इज फ्लो चार्ट? फ्लो चार्ट एक्चुअली टेल्स द फ्लो ऑफ सम पर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस, फ्लो ऑफ सम काइंड ऑफ एक्टिविटी विद पैस ऑफ टाइम, हाउ इट इज फ्लोइंग, दैट इज कॉल्ड फ्लो चार्ट। सो दीज आर वेरियस चार्ट्स विच वी शुड नो। सो दैट वॉज द क्वेश्चन, ब्रेक इवन चार्ट। ओके, लेट्स गो नेक्स्ट। वेन विल यू गेट प्रॉफिट इन ब्रेक इवन एनालिसिस? वेन सेल्स रेवेन्यू इज मोर देन टोटल कॉस्ट। सो आंसर इज ए फॉर दैट। ये मैंने आपको डायग्राम दिया था, इसमें एक टर्म याद रखना, मार्जिन ऑफ सेफ्टी क्या होता है। जैसे मैंने आपको बताया कि यहाँ पे तुम्हारे पास नीदर प्रॉफिट नॉर लॉस, सो लेट अस से क्यू स्टार इज नथिंग बट दिस इज द ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट, एंड सपोज आई कैलकुलेट इट इन 50 यूनिट्स। जब आपके पास प्रोडक्शन 50 यूनिट्स हो जाएगी तो नो प्रॉफिट नो लॉस होगा, आपके पास ना तो प्रॉफिट होगा ना लॉस होगा। पर प्रेजेंट सेल कितनी है आपकी? आपकी सेल है लेट अस से 70 यूनिट प्रेजेंटली, तो मार्जिन ऑफ सेफ्टी कितना हो गया? 70 माइनस 50, आपके पास 20 यूनिट्स का मार्जिन है सेफ्टी का। सेफ हो तुम, यू आर सेफ। व्हाई? बिकॉज द मोमेंट यू रीच ब्रेक इवन यू आर नीदर प्रॉफिट नॉर लॉस, एंड अगर सेल आपकी ब्रेक इवन से कम हो जाए तो आप लॉस में चले जाएंगे, यू विल नॉट बी सेफ। तो जितना तुम ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट से ऊपर हो उतना ही तुम सेफ हो, दैट इज बेसिकली डिफाइनिंग मार्जिन ऑफ सेफ्टी। अगेन द यूनिट ऑफ मार्जिन ऑफ सेफ्टी कैन बी नंबर ऑफ यूनिट्स, इट कैन बी इन रुपीज। अगर मैं इस ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट को रुपीज में निकालूं, सेल्स प्राइस के साथ इसको मल्टीप्लाई कर दूं, दैट वन यूनिट आई कैन सेल लेट अस से इन 1000 रुपीज, सो माय ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट इज 50,000 रुपीज, बट प्रेजेंटली आई एम डूइंग बिजनेस ऑफ 70,000 रुपीज, सो व्हाट इज माय मार्जिन ऑफ सेफ्टी? दैट इज 20,000 रुपीज। सो मार्जिन ऑफ सेफ्टी कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड इन रुपीज, इट कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड इन नंबर ऑफ यूनिट्स। ओके, सो दिस इज व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस नाउ, सो लेट्स गो फॉरवर्ड। नाउ फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट इज गिवन, वेरिएबल कॉस्ट इज गिवन पर यूनिट। एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट यू शुड ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दैट वेरिएबल कॉस्ट एंड सेलिंग प्राइस विल बी इन रुपीज पर यूनिट। सो दिस इज द वी, दिस इज द एस, दिस इज द एफ। फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट विल बी इन रुपीज। प्रोडक्शन कैपेसिटी इज 1600 यूनिट्स पर मंथ। इफ प्रोडक्शन इज कैरिड आउट एट 80% ऑफ इट्स रेटेड कैपेसिटी, तो प्रोडक्शन 1600 यूनिट है ही नहीं, एक्चुअल प्रोडक्शन कितनी है? जो क्यू हम बोल रहे हैं कितने यूनिट प्रोड्यूस किए, वो एक्चुअल प्रोडक्शन आपके पास 1600 नहीं है। क्या है? 1600 का 80%। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय 80%? 0.8 इंटू 1600, सो दैट इज द एक्चुअल प्रोडक्शन यू हैव विच इज क्यू। अब आपके पास अगर क्यू आ गया तो आपको पता लग जाएगा टोटल रेवेन्यू कितना आ गया। आपके पास रेवेन्यू आ जाएगा जो आपके पास सेलिंग प्राइस है इनटू क्यू। आपकी टोटल कॉस्ट कितनी आ जाएगी? सर फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट प्लस वेरिएबल कॉस्ट। तो प्रॉफिट कब होता है? प्रॉफिट होता है सर जब रेवेन्यू आपका कॉस्ट से ऊपर हो जाए। इन दोनों को निकालो और आपके पास प्रॉफिट आ जाएगा। सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस। सो एक्चुअल यूनिट प्रोड्यूस्ड क्यू इज 1280 यूनिट, सो दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू फॉर अस। एंड फिक्स कॉस्ट वेरिएबल कॉस्ट दैट इज इक्वल टू दिस। अब अगर सपोज क्वेश्चन में ये पूछता है कि आप बताओ इकोनॉमिक ऑर्डर क्वांटिटी कितनी है जिसमें नो प्रॉफिट नो लॉस हो जाए, तो इकोनॉमिक ऑर्डर क्वांटिटी क्या होती है जिसके ऊपर आपका रेवेन्यू इज इक्वल टू योर सेल। सो एवरीथिंग इज गिवन, यू नो 320 इंटू क्यू स्टार इज इक्वल टू नाउ 60,000 प्लस 210 इंटू क्यू स्टार। सो यू कैन कैलकुलेट क्यू स्टार एज 60,000 डिवाइडेड बाई नाउ 320 माइनस 210। हाउ मच इज दैट? 60,000 डिवाइडेड बाई नाउ 110। आर वी गेटिंग समथिंग हेयर? आई थिंक दिस इज इक्वल टू अप्रोक्सीमेटली 5.5। ओके, दिस इज द नंबर ऑफ ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट। एंड प्रेजेंटली इफ आई एम सेलिंग लेट अस से दिस मच यूनिट, तो ये मेरे पास एक प्रॉफिट मार्जिन सेफ्टी है मेरे पास, 555 पे ब्रेक इवन है एंड एज ऑफ नाउ आई एम प्रोड्यूसिंग 1280 यूनिट्स, दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इट। एनी हो दिस इज हाउ इट इज टू बी कैलकुलेटेड। गो नेक्स्ट। क्रैश प्रोग्राम ऑफ फॉर अ प्रोजेक्ट मीन्स वॉट? क्रैशिंग क्या होता है? देखो, क्रैशिंग होता है किसी प्रोजेक्ट को कंप्रेस करना, इज कॉल्ड क्रैशिंग, दैट इज कॉल्ड क्रैशिंग। सो अगर मैं तुम्हें एक नेटवर्क डायग्राम दे दूं, लेट मी गिव यू अ नेटवर्क डायग्राम एंड एक्सप्लेन यू द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस कंसेप्ट। लेट मी गिव यू दिस नेटवर्क डायग्राम। ओके, राइट, दिस इज द नेटवर्क डायग्राम विच आई एम गिविंग यू। लेट से दिस टेक एक्टिविटी टेक्स ए, दिस इज बी, दिस इज सी, दिस इज डी। एक्टिविटी ए टेक्स 2 डेज एंड बी को लगता है 3 दिन, सी को लगता है लेट अस से 2 डेज, सी ऑल्सो 2 डेज, और इसको लगता है 5 दिन, 5 डेज, राइट। सो कैन यू टेल मी इन हाउ मेनी डेज यू कैन कंप्लीट दिस एंटायर प्रोजेक्ट? मिनिमम डेज यू कैन कंप्लीट दिस एंटायर प्रोजेक्ट। देर आर 2 वेज टू रीच फ्रॉम 1 to 4। वन वे इज ए सी डी, अनदर इज बी डी। ये दो ही रास्ते हैं फ्रॉम रीचिंग फ्रॉम 1 to 4। नाउ ए सी डी, इफ आई टेक 2 + 2 = 4 + 5 = 9 एंड दिस से 3 + 5 दैट इज 8। सो दिस वन इज द लॉन्गर, दिस वन इज लॉन्गर एंड दिस वन इज कॉल्ड क्रिटिकल पाथ। रिमेंबर वन थिंग, क्रिटिकल पाथ इज द लॉन्गेस्ट पाथ ऑन द नेटवर्क डायग्राम एंड दिस इज द शॉर्टेस्ट टाइम इन विच यू कैन कंप्लीट द प्रोजेक्ट। सो वट इज सो स्पेशल अबाउट क्रिटिकल पाथ? टू थिंग्स यू नीड टू रिमेंबर। नंबर वन, क्रिटिकल पाथ इज द लॉन्गेस्ट पाथ ऑन द नेटवर्क डायग्राम। नंबर टू, इट इज द शॉर्टेस्ट टाइम इन विच यू कैन कंप्लीट द प्रोजेक्ट। शॉर्टेस्ट टाइम टू कंप्लीट द प्रोजेक्ट, दैट इज द टू थिंग्स यू नीड टू रिमेंबर अबाउट क्रिटिकल पाथ। There will be critical activities also. So I will say A, C, D are critical activities. So A, C, D are critical activities. Now B is not critical activity. A, C, D are critical activities. Very important activities. And why they are important activities? Because if there is a delay, if there is a delay in critical activity, in critical activity, entire project gets delayed. So if there is a delay in critical project, entire project gets delayed, and that is the reason these are called critical activities. But this question is not about delaying the project, it is reverse, compressing the project. Now the question is, why I am to compress the project? Answer is, this project can be completed minimum shortest time by 9 days. Now suppose the requirement is that this project should be completed in 7 days. Let's say the requirement is that it is to be completed in 7 days. So crashing or compressing means what? Crashing or compressing means what? Compressing or crashing means reducing the time of project. Reducing the time of project. I want to complete the project in lesser time. And one thing you should know, whenever you want to reduce the length of the project, you need to reduce the longest path first. That means compressing is done on the critical path. Compressing is to be done first of all on critical path, because that is where you can reduce the length. So done on critical path, this is done on critical path. That is another thing you should know. And when you reduce the length of longest path, what happens? In the process, another path may become equally long. When you reduce the length of longer line, then shorter line and longer line can become of same length. So there is a probability, let us say, I reduce C activity by 1 day. Suppose I reduce C activity by 1 day. Then the length of ACD and length of BD will become same. And there will be 2 critical paths. So compressing mein kya hota hai? There can be another critical path also. So more critical path can come up. That is the meaning of it. Third is, now this question is about basically the cost. It is not about the time. So what happens to the cost when you compress the project? Cost may increase. cost may increase, it may decrease, or it may remain same. So on this slide I have explained you what is the meaning of compressing or crashing. Compressing and crashing mein kya hota hai? Sir, time to reduce hota hi hai. Acha, kya aur bhi koi critical path ban sakta hai? Bilkul ban sakta hai. Acha, cost pe kya impact padta hai? Cost may decrease, may increase, or something like that. So now the question is related to the cost. Let's answer this question now. Cost pe kya fark padta hai? You know, there are two kind of cost. One is direct cost, another is indirect cost. Direct cost is something which is directly attributed to the basically product you are making. Jo cost direct product ke upar attribute ki ja sake. Indirect is which cannot be directly attributed. Now let me tell you something. What is the meaning of this? Direct cost, indirect cost. So cost ko I am dividing into two part. Ek cost hoti hai direct cost और एक कॉस्ट होती है इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट. इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट आई विल गिव द एग्जांपल ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स ओनली एंड एजुकेशन ओनली. डायरेक्ट रिलेटेड टू स्टूडेंट, रिलेटेड टू इंडिविजुअल स्टूडेंट, इंडिविजुअल स्टूडेंट डायरेक्टली दैट कॉस्ट विच कैन डायरेक्टली बी रिलेटेड टू इंडिविजुअल स्टूडेंट, not related to individual student, but all the students. It is not directly related to individual student, but it is related to all the students collectively. Let me give you example. Let's say college fees has increased. When you went there, that why college fees has increased? College person said that because the kind of material, books we are giving you to each student, उसका कॉस्ट बढ़ गया है, मटेरियल कॉस्ट बढ़ गया है. सो आई विल से मटेरियल कॉस्ट इज द डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट. मटेरियल कॉस्ट हैज इंक्रीज्ड. आई विल से ओके दैट इज द, देन इट इज द डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट बिकॉज इट इज डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू द पर्सन. इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट आई विल से कॉलेज वाला बोलता है कि नो यू नो दिस रेंट ऑफ द बिल्डिंग इन विच वी आर रनिंग क्लास दैट हैज इंक्रीज्ड. No, rent cannot be directly assigned to individual student. So student will not be in position to know that because of increase in rent, how much my fees should increase. Individually, he cannot analyze that. Though rent has increased and petrol ka cost badh gaya hai, jaise main ye bolun ke petrol cost badh gaya hai, let us say, to usse student ki fees pe kya impact padna chahiye? To wo indirectly related hai. Yes, because inflation has gone up, your this cost will increase, but it is not directly related. This is how it is to be done. Now, direct cost basically and indirect cost ko I can be, also link with the time. Now, if I talk about the basically direct and indirect cost, then you know with the time, one is directly with respect to time, indirect cost and duration ke saath, and direct cost duration ke saath relation alag hai. You need to understand that with the time, direct cost is not basically direct cost. If I say direct cost and time are inversely related, whereas direct cost and time, indirect cost and time is directly related. So try to understand this. Indirect cost, I said rent. Suppose I am hiring a building for 1 year, then rent will be for 1 year. Suppose I am hiring the building for 6 months because project is running for 6 months. So I am hiring the building for 6 months and project is running for 6 months because I am talking about here project. I am to complete a project. You see, this is a project which I am to do. This is a project. Now this project is going on for 6 months. I am to pay rent for 6 months. This project is going for 1 year. I am to pay rent for 1 year. So with the time, what happens is indirect cost is directly related to time. That as the time increases, indirect cost increases. As the time increases, direct cost basically decreases. And as I shorten the time to complete the project, time decreases. Let me give you an example. Suppose I want to complete this project not in 9 days but in 7 days or 8 days. Isko kam karo. To aap bologe sir mereko jyada material cost lana padega, mereko achhi machine lani padegi, mereko jyada log lagane padenge. अगर तुम 9 days में इसको normally complete करते हो तो तुम्हें material, manpower normally चाहिए, लेकिन if you want to complete it in less time because of your urgency, then you have to complete it, you have to hire more costly material, you have to purchase, you have to hire more costly manpower and your direct cost will increase. You understand that? So basically what you have to remember is, like, with time direct cost is indirectly related and indirect cost is directly related. And if you see now, if I'm crashing the project, means I am reducing its time, that is a crashing the project. Now tell me, when I crash or compress the project, what happens to indirect cost? Sir, it decreases. What happens to direct cost? It increases. And what happens to total cost? It may increase, it may decrease. So let me sum up now. What is compressing or crashing the project? Sir, reducing its time. And what about its cost? It may increase, it may decrease. Why? Because, sir, indirect cost decreases, direct cost increases, overall cost may increase, may decrease. That is the meaning of this particular part. Let's go to this now. Fixed cost is given, variable cost is given, sales price is given, break even point you have to calculate. I think we have just done similar question. So total sale is equal to total cost, and then we get the break even point. So F over, what is break even sale? This is what I have written. Break even sale is fixed cost over sale price per unit minus variable cost per unit. So from there we can get F is 66,000, S is 12 per unit, V is 10 per unit, and from where we get this cost, basically break even point. Okay, fixed cost per month is this, variable cost is this, selling price is this. Now the profit is to be achieved. How do you get profit? Sir, profit is nothing but revenue minus total expenditure or cost, SQ minus F plus VQ, that is P. That means S minus V into Q minus F. That means if I want to get profit of, P, I need to produce unit Q. If I want to get profit of P, I need to produce unit Q. Now, if your profit is to be zero, then you get break-even point. So, if P becomes zero, Q is Q star. What is Q star? This is break-even point. And how much is that Q star? That is F over S minus V. Any idea what will be loss? Loss is, if you want to get loss, if you want to calculate loss, then that means total cost will be more than your selling. So it will be F plus V minus S into Q. Then you will get the basically loss, and in that case your loss will be more. And normally loss will take place when your S is less than V, something like that. So in absolute term, this is how you calculate the loss. I think this is how you have calculated it. Break-even analysis can be used for short term, long term, average of two run analysis, or no such criteria. What do you think? So it is short term analysis. You know why I called it short term analysis? Because after that steady state should come. So if you see the timings, then you do the analysis for particular production. After that, production should increase. So break even means sort of gestation period. So when you will achieve that particular state, when your total expenditure and total revenue is equal. So short term analysis kiya jata hai, short term ke andar, till when you will be in losses, I will say. So break even, till break even point, till break even, losses occur. At break even, no profit, no loss. No loss. After break even, once you hit break even, then profit starts coming. Profit starts. Now you tell me, what organization would like? Organization would like that it should enter into profit phase as soon as possible. And till it does not enter into profit, it is in losses. So it should be very short term. it should be short term when you are in loss. Obviously, common sense. And when you are in loss, you have not hit the break even point. So, break even point ka analysis aap bahut short term ke liye karna chahte ho, so that within this particular time you are in losses. Let's go forward. So, which lines intersect? We have done that. At break even, which two lines intersect? This is the quantity, this is the cost. So, sir, one is the revenue line, total revenue, the slope of that is more, and this is the total cost line. So, this is the total cost line, and you understand this slope, if this angle is theta, or let's call it alpha. So, tangent alpha is nothing but this is the sale price per unit, and if this slope is beta, tangent beta is variable cost per unit. You know, the slope is nothing but rupees per unit. This is rupees and this is unit, and this one is the fixed cost, this one is F. So, understand now, the slope of total cost line gives you variable cost, slope of revenue line gives you S, and S should be more than V, and hence the slope of revenue line is more than slope of total cost line. So, wherever these two interact, what we get is, we get the break even point. So, this point is break even point, and this particular production is break even production. So, which point is break even? The point at which, sir, total cost line intersect with sales revenue line, that is the meaning of it. So, I think answer is D for that. Okay, so this is the recovery of both, we have already done that, I think by mistake it is again there. Now, let's talk little bit about ABC analysis. What do you mean by ABC analysis? It actually is related to inventory. This topic is related to inventory. So, Saklani sir will be doing inventory, inventory classification. You can relate this topic to inventory classification of items and material management. You know, these two terms, material management and inventory, I can call it. So, A items, B items and C items. It is said that in my inventory or my stock, jo maine stock rakha hai, usme teen tarah ke items hain. Items A are less in number, more in value, Jaise ghar mein jewelry hoti hai, wo A item hota hai. घर में जो ज्वेलरी है दैट इज आइटम ए. सी मोर इन नंबर, मोर इन क्वांटिटी, लेस इन वैल्यू या रुपी. जैसे क्लोथ्स, घर में कपड़े, घर में जो क्लोथ्स होते हैं तुम्हारे, या वेजिटेबल्स, दैट इज सी आइटम. एंड बी इन बिटवीन, मॉडरेट, बी इज मॉडरेट. सो एंटायर basically inventory can be classified, the items in inventory can be classified in these three categories: A, less number, more value. And strict inventory management, strict material management is to be done for item A. And kyunki ye mehengi cheez hai, isko bade dhyan se rakhna padega, strict inventory is to be managed, and you should try that you do not keep it at home. You should try that ज्वेलरी ना रखी जाए, बिकॉज दैट इज द मनी यू हैव बेसिकली ब्लॉक्ड. ज्वेलरी आपके पास कितने पैसे की पड़ी है? सर 10 लाख रुपए की ज्वेलरी पड़ी है. उस पर कितना इंटरेस्ट मिल रहा है? जरा भी इंटरेस्ट नहीं मिल रहा है. तो 10 लाख बैंक में रखो, इंटरेस्ट मिलेगा. 10 लाख को बिजनेस में लगा दो, ग्रोथ मिलेगी. सो आइटम ए आर वेरी कॉस्टली, एंड इफ यू परचेज देम एंड कीप देम विद यू, दैट इज द मनी यू हैव केप्ट इन योर अलमीरा. इट शुड नॉट बी डन. सो the term, there is a term called just in time. Just in time means you purchase that thing when it is required. Tomorrow is the marriage, purchase jewelry, do the marriage, sell it out, again use the money in circulation. I am just giving you a hypothetical example. So, just in time should be done with item A, that is very important. So, ABC analysis mein entire inventory is classified into A item, B item, C item. A items are jewelry, B items are your fridge, your TV, your laptop, you know, C items are clothes, shoes, vegetables at home. So C item, don't worry, keep them. ज़्यादा पैसा नहीं लगेगा, रखनी पड़ती हैं, इनके ऊपर ज़्यादा ध्यान देने की रिक्वायरमेंट नहीं है, राइट? हाँ, तो A items are normally 10% of quantity is only 10%. Economic order quantity. Economic order quantity क्या है? ये inventory में तुम पढ़ते हो. So in inventory, you know, whenever you have to place some order, you have to purchase something, then one is called ordering cost. When I am to place the order, I am to purchase something, I am to basically initiate the purchase order. So those formalities are to be done. And the second is, I am to maintain the inventory and holding cost or carrying cost of inventory. Space, uska rent, that is called holding cost. And how much quantity should I purchase to maintain the inventory? Inventory is a necessary evil. You are to maintain the inventory to give the service to customer. If you do not have inventory, if you do not have stock in your shop, I give you example. I am running the pharma shop, let's say. Medicines, customer comes, sir, ye medicine hai, main bolunga nahi, maine to nahi rakha hai. To customer I lose. Whenever a customer comes, if I say no, I don't have it, aap bata do, main mangwa lunga, to dusri dukan pe chala jayega, I lost my customer. But if I keep all the medicines and customer does not come for 3 months, maybe expiry date comes and I lose my stock. So it is a very, you know, you need to make a balance. You need to keep the items to serve the customer. But at the same time, if you keep the items, you need to give more money to purchase these items. So you need to place optimum order so that minimum cost of having inventory is incurred. So economic order quantity is the optimum cost or minimum cost to retain the inventory, placing the order, or how much order should I place? What optimum order should I place? That is called optimum economic order quantity. What optimum order I must place? I must place to minimize the cost of maintaining inventory, etc. Now there is a formula. I am sure you know this formula. Economic order quantity is 2D C naught over C H. C naught is the, D is the basically demand. How much order, how much is the demand? Annual demand or something. How much is the annual demand? C naught is the ordering cost. How much cost will be incurred in ordering? C H is the holding cost for inventory. Holding cost for inventory. I mean, I am maintaining the inventory. I cannot place entire order in one go. Ordering cost kam ho jayega, lekin holding cost badh jayega. Sari cheezein kahan rakhoge aap? So you cannot do that. So economic order quantity is 2D C naught over C H. That is a formula. Now in the exam, he will ask you question related to that. Ordering cost is increased to 16 times. So what will happen to economic order quantity? So C naught has increased by 16 times. It has become 4 times. Very simple question. What happens if we increase economic order quantity? What happens if we increase the economic order quantity? If we do that, just see what is the answer. You know, actually this question is taken from some Public Service Commission exam. And their 4 choices given were like this. These were the 4 choices. So if I increase, the question is not very well framed, but yes, if economic order quantity increase, then what happens? What happens to inventory carrying cost? What happens to ordering cost? What happens to total cost? Something like that. Now see, as the order quantity, the quantity which you are ordering, as that quantity which you are ordering increases, then ordering cost decreases, holding cost increases. Ordering cost decreases, holding cost increases. And total cost ka diagram kuch aisa banta hai. So total cost is optimum, which is called economic order quantity. Now as the quantity increases, so first total cost decreases and then it increases. Increase in economic word is something which I don't think should be there. As I increase in the quantity to be ordered, what happens is first the total cost will decrease and then the total cost will increase. So actually the ordering cost decreases, so this is the variation. If I talk about the variation with the quantity I ordered, so ordering cost will decrease, you know, holding cost will increase, something like that, and total cost will be something like this. This is the total cost, this is the holding cost, and this is ordering cost. So as the number of orders increase, ordering cost increase. As the quantity per order increases, holding cost increases, ordering cost decreases. Now as the Q increases, what happens? Total cost decreases and then increases, and at some point it is economic order quantity. So the question was actually what happens when this is happening. I hope you understood this. So how do you classify ABC values? ABC analysis mein classify kaise karte hain? उनके वैल्यू से करते हैं, नंबर से करते हैं, प्रायोरिटी से करते हैं, किस से करते हैं? आंसर इज हम उनकी वैल्यू से करते हैं. मैंने क्या बताया? ए आइटम क्या है? आई टोल्ड यू ए आइटम ज्वेलरी. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय ज्वेलरी? मैं ज्वेलरी जब बोल रहा हूं तो मैं उसकी क्या कर रहा हूं? वैल्यू तो कर रहा हूं. ओके. सी आइटम मैंने क्या बताया? मैंने बोला क्लोथ्स. सो अगर हमसे कोई पूछे कि क्लोथ्स और ज्वेलरी में तुम संभाल के किस चीज को रखते हो, आप बोलेंगे सर हम ज्वेलरी को रखते हैं. Less value, and then I said okay, what is B? B is your laptop, let us say. So laptop bhi aapka valuable hai, but not as valuable as jewelry. So as per value we have classified these items, because if the value is more, I need to invest more money. Value more, that is items A, more investment I need to do, more investment. And if I am doing more investment, I need to take care of these items more. That is the meaning of this. Annual demand is 3200 parts, unit cost is this, inventory carrying charges are 25% per annum, that is nothing but this is the carrying cost, you know, holding cost. Holding cost is always calculated basically on the total cost of the item. So per annum 25% means if there is a basically total cost, total worth of inventory, let us say total worth of inventory is rupee 1 lakh, that means the items which you are having with you is 1 lakh rupees, so holding cost will be 25% of total worth of your inventory. तो क्या हो जाएगा? 25K आपके पास उसका होल्डिंग कॉस्ट बन जाएगा. उसको मेंटेन करने के लिए 25,000 रुपए मेरे को रिक्वायर्ड है. दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इट. एंड वन प्रोक्योरमेंट. प्रोक्योरमेंट क्या होता है? एक ऑर्डर. एक ऑर्डर मेरे को कितने में पड़ेगा? रुपीज 150. तो मेरे को कितने ऑर्डर करने चाहिए? यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट? सो एनुअल डिमांड, दिस इज डी. Unit cost is also given to you. So let's try to understand this now. Holding cost is unit cost per unit. Holding cost per unit 25%. If the per unit cost is 6 rupee, 1 lakh of all items, let's say 1 unit is 6 rupee, holding cost is this much rupee, ordering cost is this much. That is how it was. You were to calculate the number of orders to be placed per year. Very simple question. Hardly there is anything in this. Okay, there are 300 spark plugs to be produced in one shift of 8 hours. Standard time is 1.5 time. Standard time per piece. One piece is taking 1.5 minute for production. So, you know how much pieces are you producing in one shift? 300 spark plugs. So, one piece takes 1.5 minutes. 300 pieces takes this minute. And divided by this, so this hour of job you are doing, should I calculate it? 6 5s the 300, so I am doing job of 7.5 hour in 8 hour shift. I have 8 hour shift, so obviously half an hour I am taking break. Now listen carefully, one item is taking 1.5 minutes, how many items are there? 300. So how much is the total time required to make them? 7.5 hours. In the shift of 7 shift of 8 hours, I am doing a job worth 7.5 hours. So, what is the output or productivity? Productivity is 7.5 over 8. That is the productivity for me. 7.5 over 8 is nothing but 15 by 16. If the demand is doubled, ordering cost is halved, economic order pay kya fark padega? Very simple question. D becomes 2D, ordering cost becomes C naught by 2, and this will remain unchanged. Go to next. Annual demand 900, ordering cost 100, holding cost 2 per unit. Economic order quantity kya hogi? So, this actually is D 900 to D C naught by C carrying. This is the answer for that. Okay, so what happens to A class of items? I told you A class, B class, C class, these are the inventory. These are the inventory items, A item, B item, C items, all inventory items. So, very strict control is required. Frequent review of their for their consumption. Safety stock is kept. What do you follow? What do you do in A class of items? Okay, let's see the answer. Why not 3? What do you think is not 3? Safety stock kept. What do you mean by that? See, I told you A class mein hum just in time lagate hain. Just in time means what? Minimum inventory. Minimum inventory means place order when needed. Don't keep stock, maybe in the name of safety also. Stock ko rakhna hi nahi hai, usi time mangwana hai. Customer aaya, bhai sahab ye medicine hai. That medicine is very costly, value is very high. A item, 10,000 rupees ka ek injection, mere paas nahi hai. Bhai sahab, aadhe ghante mein aao, main mangwa deta hu. Come after half an hour, I'll bring it for you. A item, safety stock or any stock is not kept. You have to order then and there. So that is just in time. So no safety stock is kept. So that is the meaning of it. What is the guidelines now? A item, very strict control. Frequent ordering is to be done because I don't want to keep it there with me. Okay, maximum effort to reduce the lead time. Highest safety stock, no. Very strict control, this. Very strict control. Highest, I think, what is the question? Which is not the guidelines? Yes, not the guidelines is higher safety stock. Safety stock to rakhna hai nahi hai mere ko. Strict control rakhna hai. Frequent ordering karni hai because I don't want to keep it. Jab koi customer aayega to order kar do. Frequent order. Lead time is half an hour. Bhai sahab, aap half an hour mein aa jana. Suppose person comes, I need this injection. Okay, come after 2 days. 2 days, he will go to some another shop. Come after 15 minutes. Okay, bhai sahab, I'll wait for 15 minutes. So, keep the lead time minimum. Order frequently. Don't keep any stock with you. That is A items. Right? Depreciation is reducing. Appreciation and depreciation. Appreciation. Appreciation means what? Increase the value with the time. And what is the depreciation? Depreciation. What is the depreciation? Decrease value with the time. Now, you will give me the example. Cost of land. Cost of your vehicle. Suppose you purchase a car today in 10 lakh rupees. After 1 year, what do you think? The value will increase or decrease? Decrease. Why? Sir, wear and tear, accident, I mean, new model has come, new technology has come. Depreciation. Value decrease with passage of time because of many reasons. Technological obsolescence because of wear and tear, many reasons. Appreciation, increase the value with the time. Like what? Even some kind of liquors, you know, wine or some liquor with passage of time, fermentation process will be very good. So, when some value worth increases with time, that is called appreciation. Now there are methods to calculate depreciation, and this depreciation is calculated to know how much tax we should give and what is the book value, those kind of things, you know. And one of the method, ABC analysis is not there, time series is not there, diminishing balance method. Yes, this is one of the five methods. There are five methods, one of the five methods. We have kept the video also on this. So depreciation ka ek method ye bhi hai, diminishing balance method. Okay, ye padho jara. Interest of material manager, interest of top management, Pareto's 80-20 rule. ABC analysis ka basis kya hai? ABC analysis says that I can divide entire inventory into A category, B category, C category. Pareto 80-20 rule means 80% of the things are because of 20% of the causes. So 80% effect what you see is because of 20% cause. 80% wealth of the country is with the 20% of the people. 80% of the problems are created by these 20% of the people, something like that. So 80-20 rule means minor number leading to major effect. ABC analysis bhi kuch aisa hi hai. ABC mein tum bol rahe ho ki yaar A aur B ko agar mila dein, A aur B items ko mila dein to ye 20% hai, lekin worth cost 80% hai. Jaise A B C mein agar main A aur B ko mila dun to 20% items, but 80% वैल्यू और वर्थ, यही तो है पैरेटो एनालिसिस. तो पैरेटो का एनालिसिस भी यही बोलता है, दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इट. एंड पैरेटो वॉज बेसिकली, आई थिंक इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग, इटालियन इकोनॉमिस्ट थे जिन्होंने एनालिसिस किया कि इटली का 80% वेल्थ और लैंड एट दैट टाइम इज पोजेस्ड बाई 20% ऑफ द पीपल ओनली, और बाकी 80% लोगों के पास 20% लैंड है. तो 80-20 वर्क्स एवरीवेयर, दैट इज व्हाट ही सेड. शेड्यूलिंग का पर्पस क्या है? व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ शेड्यूलिंग? व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ शेड्यूलिंग? यू नो, पर्पस ऑफ शेड्यूलिंग इज टू गिव सम काइंड ऑफ सीक्वेंस ऑफ एक्टिविटीज, और वी हैव टू मेंटेन दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग, सीक्वेंस ऑफ ऑपरेशन. आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ दिस, मेंटेन द सीक्वेंस ऑफ ऑपरेशन, प्रोग्राम फॉर ऑपरेशन, रेगुलेट द प्रोग्रेस ऑफ जॉब थ्रू वेरियस प्रोसेसेस. शेड्यूलिंग लाइक जीरोक्स मशीन पे यू गो एंड देन ओके भाई साहब, पहले आपका काम लगेगा, उसके बाद आपका काम लगेगा. सो आई एम टू गिव सम काइंड ऑफ सीक्वेंस, फर्स्ट दिस जॉब इज टू बी डन, देन दिस जॉब इज टू बी डन, देन दिस जॉब इज टू बी डन, सो दैट एवरीथिंग बिकम्स वेल ऑर्गेनाइज्ड, दैट इज कॉल्ड शेड्यूलिंग. सो ऑल थ्री आर रीजन और बेसिकली पर्पज ऑफ शेड्यूलिंग, एंड दैट वे आई कैन मॉनिटर द प्रोग्रेस ऑल्सो, राइट. प्रोडक्शन लाइन इज बैलेंस्ड इफ at each station equal number of machine, operation time is same, there is equal number of operators, waiting time for service is same. What do you think answer is? Timings. So listen, what is the production line is balancing, line balancing wala problem. You know, if I say that production is going on, and when the part is being produced, it is to go through this production line. First, my raw material will enter. Let's say this is the raw material. This enters the workstation number one. This is workstation number one. This is workstation number two. This is workstation number three. This is workstation number four. And finished product comes out from here. So finished product comes out after fourth workstation. Now, what is the time taken at this workstation? Let us say 15 minutes. Here 20 minutes. Here 10 minutes. This side 12 minutes. Now, this is not balanced. Why? Because unequal time is taken at each workstation. Actually, kya hona chahiye? Har workstation ke upar time is equal. If that is the case, the production rate will be very smooth and there will not be any kind of inventory. Now, you see, this workstation will take 20 minutes and this fellow is free after 15 minutes. So 5 minutes usko wait karna padega. Uska time waste ho raha hai. So workstation ke upar production line will be said as balanced if the time taken at each workstation is equal. That is the meaning of it. overall production rate is decided by slowest. Now go back, and if I ask you after how much time the product will be released in the production line, the first product comes out, and after how much time the second will come out? The second will come out after 20 minutes. So cycle time will be 20 minutes. This will decide the cycle time, and cycle time only tells the production rate. So I will say that production rate is decided by the slowest workstation. Suppose there are 4 boys in a project. Unless until all do they work properly, project will not be complete. 3 do their work in 3 days. 4th says I will take 2 more days. So unless until 4th guy, the slowest fellow, completes the project, entire project cannot be submitted. So production rate is decided on the basis of slowest workstation. So remember this, production rate decided by slowest workstation. The workstation which is slowest decides the production rate. That is something you have to understand. Yeah. Stock out of a commodity. When stock is not there, when no stock, stock means item in inventory, when inventory mein stock khatam ho gaya, aap dawai ki dukaan pe gaye uske paas dawai khatam ho gayi, aap doodh ki dukaan pe gaye uske paas doodh khatam ho gaya, to kya hoga isme se? Profit loss ho jayega, customer loss ho jayega, goodwill loss ho jayegi, sab ho jayega. Customer bhi bhag gaya, uski goodwill, yaar is dukaan mein to kuch nahi milta hai, goodwill bhi chala gaya, jo tumne profit kamana tha wo bhi chala gaya, all of them, so sabka loss hai. Okay, असेंबली लाइन बैलेंसिंग का क्या बेनिफिट है? टेल मी. मिनिमाइजेस द इन प्रोसेस इन्वेंट्री, बिल्कुल सही. वर्क कंटेंट को रिड्यूस कर देता है, स्मूथ कर देता है प्रोडक्शन फ्लो को. मेंटेन्स रिक्वायर्ड रेट ऑफ आउटपुट. विच वन डू यू थिंक इज द आंसर? लेट्स सी. टू नहीं है इसके अंदर. अब टू क्यों नहीं है? वर्क कंटेंट क्या होता है? डू यू नो व्हाट इज वर्क कंटेंट? वर्क कंटेंट इज, वर्क कंटेंट is the total time summation at work station. अभी हमने पीछे एक एग्जाम्पल लिया जिसे मैंने आपको यह दिखाया. तो what is the total work content? What is the total work content is equal to 15 plus 20 plus 10 plus 12. कितना हो गया ये? 30, 45, 55, 57 मिनट. ये टोटल वर्क कंटेंट है, ये तो करना ही पड़ेगा. सपोज आई से 15 15 15 अप्रोक्सीमेटली 15, ऑल 15, दैट आल्सो विल बी ऑलमोस्ट 57. इसे से 15 14 15 14 समथिंग लाइक दैट, तो इट विल बी मोर बैलेंस्ड. 15 14 15 13 देन 57, सो इट विल बी मोर बैलेंस्ड, बट वर्क कंटेंट विल रिमेन सेम. सो आई थिंक वर्क कंटेंट डज नॉट चेंज इन दिस. It does not change work content. The rest is okay. Smooth means it will flow. No in work, in process inventory. That is correct. Okay, go next. Very simple. Standard time required assembly each item is 2244 seconds. 40 hours per week hai. 2400 items per week banani hai. Next 3 months ke liye. Small numerical. कितने आपको वर्क स्टेशन रिक्वायर्ड हैं, कितना टाइम चाहिए? 244 इज द बेसिकली ईच आइटम को असेंबल करने के लिए 244 सेकंड आर रिक्वायर्ड डिवाइडेड बाय 60. सो 4.06 इज द टाइम, टाइम ऑफ वन प्रोडक्ट, राइट? सो सी दिस नाउ, रीड दिस क्वेश्चन. ईच आइटम को आपको असेंबल करने के लिए 244 सेकंड इज रिक्वायर्ड. प्रोडक्शन लाइन इज टू बी डिजाइन टू मेक आइटम्स पर वीक. सो आई वॉन्ट टू मेक 2400 आइटम्स पर वीक, एंड पर वीक 40 आवर्स आई एम टू ऑपरेट. सो 40 आवर्स आई एम टू वर्क पर वीक. 2400 आइटम्स पर वीक आर रिक्वायर्ड, एंड ईच आइटम रिक्वायर So 2400 items per week. These are the items per week. And how much time will be required to produce these items? 244 seconds per items. This much, if I take, this much hours are required actually to complete 2400 items, and one line operates 40 hours. So one line 40 hours, total time this much, total lines you can calculate how much are there. So we need to see how many workstations we have to produce that way. Right, so this is how it is to be done. I told you this 2400 into 244 divided by 60, and that is 40 hours. From here you can calculate how many workstations or lines are required. Actually he is asking about the lines, how many lines are required to be done. This question is more related to common sense and welding. You know, welding also you will read, this is more related to that. So in 10 minutes time, dwell time, you know what is dwell time? Rest time. Rest time is this. Arcing time is machine time, the time in which you are doing machining. So 10 minutes mein agar tum 10 minutes mein 5 minute kaam kar rahe ho, to aapka welding basically aapko nikalna kya, duty cycle nikalna hai. As per American standard we take 10 minutes. So in 10 minutes if you are working for 5, then duty cycle is only 50%. Duty cycle is 50% because you take 10 minutes as per American jo usne bataya. So this as per American standard you take the 10 minutes cycle, and in 10 minutes if you are working for 5 minutes, this is how it goes. As I told you, this is more a question of basically welding, and this is typical question of welding, duty cycle ka. Duty cycle and rated current, duty cycle and rated current, formula is this. If duty cycle is taken as D and rated value of current is taken as I, then all you need to know is that D square I is constant. Remember this. If rated current and duty cycles are given, that maximum current if it is 250 ampere, then duty cycle is 100%. Let us say for 250 ampere duty cycle is 100%. You can keep on running the machine without dwelling time, without stopping, run the machine if you are running it at 250 ampere. But what if duty cycle is to be 50%? Then what current I can run it? You know, if you are to run at 50% duty cycle, that means after every 5 minutes, as per American standard, within 10 minutes, 5 minutes you have to run the machine, 5 minutes you have to give it rest. So common sense is, if I am running the machine at 250 ampere, I am not to bother. Like fan, I can keep on running the machine, 10 minutes mein se 10 minutes chalate raho, koi trouble nahi hai. Kisi ne aapko instruction diya ki fan kitni der chalana hai, ya fridge kitni der chalana hai, ek ghante mein itni der chalana hai. Did anybody give you that instruction? No. So that means duty cycle is 100%. For fridge, for fan, duty cycle is 100%. But then high power rating machines like welding machine, wo aisa nahi ki chalate raho pura din chalate raho, uska duty cycle hota hai, to wo jyada current consume karta hai. So if current consumed is more, duty cycle will reduce. To formula kya hai sir? D square I is equal to constant. If 100% ke upar itna hai, to 50% ke upar kitna hoga. So you can calculate current like this. Okay, now this particular topic, scheduling, it is related to scheduling. Which one of the following scheduling measure is not related to due date or delivery time? You know, flow time is not related to due date or delivery time, because flow time is something which takes total time. Total time jo lagega kaam mein. It is not related to how much is the late, how much is the number of tardiness, how much is the late jobs. Actually, which job is late or not late, that depends upon due date, you know, due date and delivery time. So if I say, sir, I am to submit my this project by Thursday or else I'll get late. Then there will be the question of tardiness, lateness, number of jobs which got late. Flow time is something, how much time is required for all the jobs to be done. If I have 10 jobs at hand and I am to complete all the jobs and nobody gives me due date or something, then I am to analyze ki mere ko itna kaam karna hai, pura karna hai, late ho na ho, mere ko karna hai. That is called flow time, total flow time, and that does not basically analyze the tardiness. I will discuss this question later on with you and then you will understand the meaning of this in detail. Number of events which are given in any basically project scheduling is Fulkerson rule. What is this? Let me give you the meaning of this. Maine network diagram tumhe bataya. Network diagram ka meaning hota hai that it should look like flowing forward. Activity A, activity B, activity C, activity D, activity E, activity F. Right? Now what is Fulkerson rule is that how to give number to these events. First event is given number 1, followed by second event, followed by either I can give 3 to this or 3 to this, and then I cannot say 1, 2, 3, I cannot say that. This is Fulkerson rule. So giving the numbering to events is basically the Fulkerson rule which you should know, right? So this is a very simple question. Okay, now there are two machines, cutting machine and building machine, and on two machines there are 5 jobs. Two machines are there and 5 jobs are there, and I am to make some kind of scheduling. Sequence and scheduling ka question hai ye. Sequence and scheduling ka question hai. Mere ko do jobs ko 5 jobs ko do machine pe sequencing and scheduling karna hai. Uske liye jo rule lagta hai wo aapka ye rule lagta hai, Johnson's rule. So Johnson's rule actually is related to that. So this is Johnson's rule. Johnson's rule it is, right? Okay, what is the optimum make span sequence? Optimum make span sequence. Optimum sequence क्या होता है? ये दो machines पे मैंने लगा दिया, machine 1, machine 2, ये jobs हैं. Now assumption is first every job will go to first machine. Cutting पहले होगी, first cutting then binding. First cutting will take place and then binding will take place. You will not do binding first and then cutting. That is assumption. Now what is, how the sequence is to be done? Find out the minimum processing time on first machine. This is basically the processing time given. Time required, basically processing time required is, time is given on each machine. The minimum time on first machine is to be sequenced first. Find the minimum time. If it is on the first machine, it is to be sequenced first. Now after 2, we come to 4. Now 4 is on the second machine. If the minimum time comes on first machine, sequence it first. How many jobs are there? 5 jobs are there. I am to sequence it. So if the minimum processing time is on the first machine, sequence it first. Now the minimum time comes is 4. It is on the second machine. Sequence it at the last. So this basically job number 5 is to be sequenced the last. So this is gone. This is also gone. Now what is the next left? 5. Now it comes on the first machine. It is to be sequenced first. So it is to be sequenced here. So pehle ye sequence ho gaya, fir ye aapka 5th job last mein chali gayi, fir ye aapki yahan pe aa gayi. Ab dekho uske baad kaun sa hai. Uske baad hai 6. 6 kahan pe aata hai? 6 aata hai pehli machine pe. To ye jo basically aapki second job hai, ye bhi aapki yahan pe aa jayegi. And then what is left is 1. Then what is left is 1. Understand? So I think we have made this. So ye first job thi, job number 3 jiska sabse kam tha, job number 3 was to be sequenced first because 2 was minimum, sequenced first, and then after that it was 4 means job number 5, it was to be sequenced as last. This was to be sequenced as first, job number 3. Uske baad it was 5, job number 4, after that 6, that was to be basically on machine number 1, 2, and then what is left is this. So, rule is, if there are 2 machines and n number of jobs, then see the minimum time on machine 1 or machine 2. If it is on machine 1, then sequence it first. If it is on machine 2, sequence it last. Johnson rule. Very simple rule, and that is what we follow. Okay, standardization means what? What do we mean by standardization? That is a question. What do you mean by standardization? Standardization actually is all these points which are mentioned. Dimension, machine element, testing, composition, everything. Standardization means, like aap charger lete ho, charger ka holder hota hai. Standardization means har mobile ke andar wo same holder you can use. So that means dimension of the machine element, that dimension should fit, testing method should be same, composition and properties of engineering material should be same. All these things are the part of your standardization. So when we say standardization, that simply means we are to include or we are to consider everything. That is the meaning of standardization, right? So we have to consider all these components. This we have done, basically line balancing. So what is the balance delay? No, one fellow is taking 80, then 60, then 70, then 70, then 70. Total work content. What is the total work content? Sir, I am to add this 80 plus 60 plus 70 plus 70 plus 70. What is the, you know, cycle time? Cycle time is the slowest guy, 80 second. What is the basically line efficiency? Line efficiency is total work content when you add it. So 80 plus 60 plus 70 plus 70 plus 70 divided by 80 second is the cycle time which every station is going to take. Every fellow is going to wait for 80 second, because unless until this fellow does the work, everybody is to wait into 100. That is line efficiency, and 100% minus line efficiency is balance delay. So that will be the balance delay. So I think this divided by total, that is what you get, balance delay. So this total work content divided by total, this is the line efficiency. What do you mean by productivity of a production system? Is it related to efficiency, or is it related to efficiency, input of machine, output of machine, or what? It is related to what? So answer is, it is related to productivity, is related to efficiency of the machine. So this is actually related to the efficiency of the. Okay, so let's go for now next question. And next question is related to production of large turbo generator is example of what? That is a question for us. Now you see, there are different production systems. We have a continuous production system, batch production system, mass production system, you know, project based production system. So we have different production system. Large turbo generator is example of what? That is a question for us. You know, job order production. What is the meaning of job order production for us? Job order production is one job, single job. We have got order for single job order. And we need to complete this job first. Like manufacturing of aeroplane, manufacturing of ship, manufacturing of large turbo generator. So what happens is, like if I talk about aeroplane, let me give you the diagram. Maybe you understand, this is the front part of aeroplane. So all the machines will be brought close to aeroplane. So let's say we are to manufacture aeroplane. So all machine 1, machine 2, machine 3, machine 4, all these machines will be brought close to that particular product which I am making, and that is called a job. And I am to complete this job, single job. Now, what happens in the mass production? Line production or mass production? If I say there is a line of all the machines and the product is coming to one machine and then going to another machine, so this is the mass production system. Mass production system, next version of that is continuous production system. So job production system, this is a job production system. I can say manufacturing of aeroplane is example of job production system, where all the machines are brought close to the particular job which you are making, and then you have to complete that job. On the extreme side of job production system is the continuous production system. So job production system, batch production system, then comes mass production system, then comes continuous production system. It is like this. So jab bahut si small items are repeatedly to be made, that is mass production system. So one product after another product keep on moving in a line, and this is also called line production system. Line balancing we discussed. So this is example of job production system. Let's go next now. In a line balancing, there are four tasks given. I think in this question there is some data which is basically not given appropriately. So let me give you this question. Let's say I have couple of tasks to be done. So I am given the task. Task is task 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Time taken by each task, let us say, is 10 minutes. Then 8 minutes, then let's say 15 minutes, then let us say 20 minutes, 17 minutes, right? So this is given to us. There are 5 tasks and they are to be completed in this much time. Now for the line balancing, what do you think should be the kind of workstation we create? For the cycle time, let us say, he has also given you for the cycle time of 20 minutes. So suppose we have cycle time of 20 minutes, then how many workstations should be there? That is a question. So as you can see, 8 plus 10, if the precedence permit, precedence means, is it possible that task number 1 and 2 I can club together and put in first workstation? So pehle workstation number 1 pe maine in dono ko rakh diya. 18 minutes are taken by first workstation, workstation number 1. Second workstation pe maine 15 minutes lagaye, this is workstation 2. Third pe 20 minutes will be there, because I cannot club now any other. I cannot club even 15 plus 8, because that will exceed 20. And then 17, and this is how it all goes. So, mere paas kitna workstation ho gaya? Mere paas 4 workstation ho gaya, and there are 5 tasks. So, that kind of question. So, I think there is some kind of information which I need here. Ye 4 jo task diye the, this question is related to that. So, how much will be the line efficiency for this particular thing? So, line efficiency kaise nikalenge? आपका टोटल वर्क कंटेंट कितना हो गया? टोटल वर्क कंटेंट, यू प्लीज ऐड एंटायर, देन दैट इज अ टोटल वर्क कंटेंट. यू अंडरस्टैंड? सो दिस 35 एंड दिस आल्सो 35, 70 मिनट इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग, 70 मिनट, 17 प्लस 18 इज 35, दिस इज आल्सो 35, तो 70 मिनट इज द वर्क कंटेंट. एंड साइकिल टाइम हमने बोल दिया इज 20 मिनट, साइकिल टाइम इज 20 मिनट. So what is the line efficiency? If we are to calculate line efficiency, 70 divided by 4 into 20, that is 80 into 100. So that is the line efficiency. And you know, balance delay is nothing but 100 minus line efficiency, that is a balance delay. This is how this question is asked. So you have to see the work content, and then accordingly you have to make the workstation. This is how it is to be done. So I think this question was requiring some more data. Okay, who made just in time? I'm very sure all of us know what is just in time. That means zero inventory. वही हम लोग तब से discuss कर रहे हैं. Zero inventory को ही just in time बोलते हैं. और एबीसी एनालिसिस अगर हमें कोई बताए तो ए कंटेंट ए आइटम्स के लिए जीरो इन्वेंट्री इज समथिंग विच इज एडवाइजेबल, तो जस्ट इन टाइम उसके लिए रेलिवेंट है। ताइचियो ओनो इज द पर्सन हु बेसिकली केम आउट विद दिस एंड ही वॉज फ्रॉम टोयोटा प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम। टोयोटा प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम को लीन प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम या थिन प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम भी बोलते हैं। लीन और थिन प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम, एफिशिएंट प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम। हाउ द प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम विल बिकम एफिशिएंट? इट विल बिकम एफिशिएंट इफ देर इज नो वेस्टेज, इफ वेस्टेज इज मिनिमम। सो कानबान सिस्टम जो फ्लो लॉजिस्टिक के साथ डील करता है, जस्ट इन टाइम, नो इन्वेंट्री एंड दिस लीन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सिस्टम और टोयोटा प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम, दे ऑल आर लिंक्ड हेयर। सो दिस इज जस्ट इन टाइम प्रोडक्शन और टोयोटा प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम, रिड्यूसिंग द टाइम बिटवीन प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम एज वेल एज रिस्पॉन्स टाइम फ्रॉम सप्लायर और कस्टमर। सो इसको हमने डेवलप, ये जापान में ओनो ने इसको डेवलप किया था, इसको टोयोटा के ये इंजीनियर थे जिन्होंने इसको डेवलप किया था। सो आई थिंक वी नो दिस। ओके, नाउ वी हैव गॉट फाइव जॉब्स हेयर एंड यू नो फॉर ईच जॉब प्रोसेसिंग टाइम भी दे रखा है और ड्यू डेट भी दे रखी है। प्रोसेसिंग टाइम भी दे रखा है और ड्यू डेट भी दे रखी है। सो ये जो कॉलम है, दिस इज वी हैव फाइव जॉब्स, प्रोसेसिंग टाइम दे रखा है और ड्यू डेट दे रखी है। क्वेश्चन ये पूछा है कि इसको अर्लीस्ट ड्यू डेट के हिसाब से इसको सीक्वेंस करो। देखो अब ये क्वेश्चन है सीक्वेंसिंग का। सीक्वेंसिंग मीन्स देर आर डिफरेंट जॉब्स एंड आई एम टू बेसिकली सीक्वेंस दीज जॉब्स इन फ्रंट फॉर सम पर्टिकुलर मशीन। लेट्स से एक मेरे पास मशीन पड़ी हुई है, सिंगल मशीन। ये कौन सा क्वेश्चन है? वन मशीन एंड एन जॉब्स, वन मशीन एन जॉब्स सीक्वेंस का क्वेश्चन है। अब एक मशीन पड़ी हुई है और मेरे पास जॉब्स हैं ए बी सी डी ई। लेट्स से दिस इज द जीरोक्स मशीन, जीरोक्स मशीन है और ये जॉब्स हैं जिनके ऊपर प्रोसेसिंग होनी है। नाउ टेल मी विच जॉब शुड बी गिवन प्रायोरिटी। सबसे पहले कौन सी जॉब को प्रायोरिटी मिले, उसके लिए सीक्वेंसिंग मॉडल्स हैं हमारे पास। देर आर सर्टन सीक्वेंस मॉडल, सीक्वेंस मॉडल कैन बी फर्स्ट कम फर्स्ट सर्व, फर्स्ट कम फर्स्ट सर्व, लास्ट कम फर्स्ट सर्व कैन ऑल्सो बी देयर, दैट इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल। फर्स्ट कम फर्स्ट सर्व, लास्ट कम फर्स्ट सर्व, और देर कैन बी यू नो दिस शॉर्टेस्ट प्रोसेसिंग टाइम और देर कैन बी अर्लीएस्ट ड्यू डेट, अर्लीएस्ट ड्यू डेट या स्लैक टाइम रिमेनिंग। सो ये हमारे पास सीक्वेंसिंग मॉडल है, फर्स्ट कम फर्स्ट सर्व, जो पहले आ गया उसको पहले सर्विस मिल जाए। जीरोक्स मशीन पे मैं पहले आ गया, मेरे को सर्विस मिल जाए। ये भी हो सकता है लास्ट में आए, पहले सर्विस मिल जाए, अर्जेंसी। लेट्स से मैंने बोला कि बहुत ही अर्जेंट है भाई साहब, कर दो प्लीज। लास्ट कम फर्स्ट सर्व, शॉर्टेस्ट प्रोसेसिंग टाइम, जिसमें प्रोसेसिंग टाइम सबसे कम है, जैसे जिसका प्रोसेसिंग टाइम सबसे कम है टू, उसको सबसे पहले सीक्वेंस किया जाए। तो अगर मैं शॉर्टेस्ट प्रोसेसिंग टाइम देखूं, इफ आई सी शॉर्टेस्ट प्रोसेसिंग टाइम, शॉर्टेस्ट प्रोसेसिंग टाइम एसपीटी, कैन यू सीक्वेंस सीक्वेंस द जॉब्स ऑन दिस मशीन एज पर शॉर्टेस्ट प्रोसेसिंग टाइम? दैट जॉब इज टू बी गिवन प्रायोरिटी फॉर विच द प्रोसेसिंग टाइम इज मिनिमम। लेट अस से बी विल बी द फर्स्ट टू गेट जीरोक्स, आफ्टर दैट डी विल गेट द चांस टू गेट जीरोक्स, आफ्टर दैट वी हैव ए, आफ्टर दैट वी हैव गॉट सी एंड देन ई। ई इज गोइंग टू टेक मैक्सिमम टाइम, सो दैट इज 9 days और 9 minutes, सो आई विल सीक्वेंस इट एट द लास्ट। नाउ ऑन टिपिकल जीरोक्स मशीन यू बेसिकली डू इट एज पर शॉर्टेस्ट प्रोसेसिंग टाइम। वाई? बिकॉज द पर्सन विच इज हैविंग ओनली 2 pages टू बी जीरोक्स्ड, हिज वर्क विल बी डन इमीजिएटली एंड देर इज अ बेनिफिट फॉर दैट। द पर्सन हु इज हैविंग 9 pages ही मे टेक टाइम। सो भाई साहब थोड़ा वेट करो, मैं इसको फ्री कर देता हूँ। बी के पास कम काम था, इसका काम कम है, प्रोसेसिंग कम लगेगी, मैं उसको फ्री कर देता हूँ। एडवांटेज क्या होता है शॉर्टेस्ट प्रोसेसिंग टाइम का? मिनिमम इन प्रोसेस इन्वेंट्री, मिनिमम इन प्रोसेस इन्वेंट्री। वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट? दैट मीन्स जो लोग वहां जेरोक्स मशीन पे वेट कर रहे हैं, दैट इज इन प्रोसेस इन्वेंट्री, तो कम लोग वेट करेंगे क्योंकि मैंने बी को फ्री कर दिया, मैंने ए को फ्री कर दिया। लेट से अगर मैं ई को सबसे पहले लगाता, सपोज मैं ई को लगाता, तो ई जब तक 9 मिनट्स मेरे पास ई का काम चल रहा है, एवरीबडी इज स्टैंडिंग देयर बिकॉज आई एम प्रज्यूमिंग एवरीबडी केम टूगेदर एट द सेम टाइम। अब सब के सब लोग वेट करेंगे, अदरवाइज क्या होगा, बी ने अपना काम कर लिया, डी ने अपना काम कर लिया, सो 5 मिनट में 2 लोग चले गए, अभी 5 मिनट के बाद 3 ही लोग बचे, तो इन प्रोसेस इन्वेंट्री कम है। देन कम्स अर्लीएस्ट ड्यू डेट। ड्यू डेट मीन्स व्हेन यू वांट टू गेट योर वर्क डन, सो हूएवर इज हैविंग ड्यू डेट अर्ली इज टू बी गिवन प्रायोरिटी। सो कैन यू टेल मी अर्लीएस्ट ड्यू डेट किसका है, बी का है, तो बी इज टू बी गिवन प्रायोरिटी फॉलोड बाई ए, सो बी के बाद ए को मिलेगा एंड ए के बाद डी को मिलेगा, डी के बाद सी को मिलेगा, सी के बाद ई को मिलेगा, जिसका अर्ली ड्यू डेट है उसको प्रायोरिटी मिलेगा। सो यू टेक ड्यू डेट एंड यू गो। व्हाट इज एडवांटेज ऑफ दैट, एडवांटेज इज नंबर ऑफ जॉब्स गेटिंग लेट आर मिनिमम because we are sequencing as per the due date, that means if you do not get your work done before due date you get late, which is also called tardiness. Tardiness is positive lateness, so you get tardiness, you get late, so the number of jobs which are getting late will be minimum in case of earliest due date sequence or earliest due date model. So I think this is what is the earliest due date concept, this is what we should know. Now let me tell you some advantages of earliest due date and shortest processing time, and what is the meaning of flow time. Maybe I give you some example to explain it. Okay, so before we go forward, I will give you this example and then we solve it. Let me give you some example here. You see, I'm giving you some jobs, let's say A, B, C, D, E, these jobs only I'm saying. So can you tell me what is the completion time as per shortest processing time. मैंने shortest processing time लगा दिया, तो सबसे पहले A आ गया, after that A comes C, after that comes let us say B, then comes D, then comes E. Now what is the processing time, let us say what is the processing time for that. So processing time for A is 2 days or 2 minutes, whatever you call it, then 3, then 6, then 8, then 9. This is the processing time for each job. Now, there is something which is called completion time. So let's calculate completion time. What do we know by completion time? And you know, this completion time is basically also called flow time. But let's say what is the meaning of completion time. So completion time says that A will be completed after 2 days. Then C will be completed 2 plus 3 after 5 days. B will be completed 5 plus 6, 11 days. Then 19 days, then 28 days. So completion time for each, I can understand this is the completion time. So all the jobs will be completed. So total completion time or total flow time. This is completion time is also called flow time. You know what is the meaning of flow time? फ्लो टाइम मीन्स टोटल टाइम टेकन। सो जीरोक्स मशीन वाला कब फ्री हो जाएगा, हम बोलेंगे 28 मिनट्स के बाद सारे लोगों का काम हो जाएगा, एवरीबडी विल गो एंड मशीन विल बी फ्री, दैट इज कॉल्ड फ्लो टाइम। नो देर इज समथिंग विच इज कॉल्ड मीन फ्लो टाइम ऑल्सो, देर इज समथिंग विच इज कॉल्ड मीन फ्लो टाइम ऑल्सो। हाउ डू यू कैलकुलेट मीन फ्लो टाइम, डू यू नो वट इज द टोटल फ्लो टाइम एंड हाउ मेनी जॉब्स आर देर, 5। So total flow time is 28 minutes and there are 5 jobs. So on an average, what is the flow time? 28 by 5 is the mean flow time or average flow time. Now one thing is very commonly asked in the exam is average in process inventory. Average in process inventory. How do you calculate average in process inventory? This is something which is very, very important. So remember that for first two minutes, all 5 jobs were waiting on the Xerox machine. See this carefully. For first 2 minutes, all 5 jobs were waiting for service. That is the inventory. Jobs are inventory. Okay, after 2 minutes, what happens? वन जॉब्स गो आउट एंड नेक्स्ट थ्री मिनट्स के लिए फोर जॉब्स आर वेटिंग, एग्री और नॉट? फॉर द नेक्स्ट थ्री मिनट्स सी बी डी ई आर getting waiting on the Xerox machine for getting service. First 2 minutes A B C D E all 5 are there. Next 3 minutes 4 jobs are waiting. Next 6 minutes how many? 3 are waiting. Next 8 minutes 2 are waiting. And last 9 minutes 1 job is only waiting. So that is basically how many jobs are waiting multiply by the time. So this is the total job hours or total job minute which actually they were waiting divided by now total time. So 2 minutes plus 3 minutes plus 6 minutes plus 8 minutes plus 9 minutes. So that comes out to be 2 plus 3 plus 6 plus 8 plus 9, right? So that is 28. So moment you divide it by total time, then that gives you average in process inventory, average in process inventory. And you know the advantage of shortest processing time is you get minimum average in process inventory. And I also want to tell you one more thing, whether you take sequence shortest processing time or earliest due date, whether shortest processing time or earliest due date, mean this flow time is going to remain same, because flow time is nothing but total time taken. Let's say first you take 3, then 3 plus 2 5, then 6 11. So flow time does not change. So that is very very important, that flow time is not going to change. I hope you understood this now. Okay. Right, so I think now this part of sequencing you have understood. Let's go forward now and understand what is the meaning of dispatching. Dispatching kisko bolte hain? Releasing the material and component from store to the first process. Haan. Dispatch karna means order, dispatch karna means production ko initiate karna. So process to process, drawing instruction sheet, sabko issue karna, this is nothing but basically dispatching. So what are the functions of dispatching? Check the availability of input material and ensure that movement of material from store to the first process goes. Process to process, availability of production and inspection aids, requisite drawing and specification. So this is called dispatching. Don't think dispatching means final product ko aapne basically packaging kiya. Dispatching ko packaging ke saath confuse nahi karna. Dispatching is not that final product is to be dispatched to the customer. Dispatching is internal to organization. Actually, when you start making something, when you start releasing the material, the drawings, the technical specification, us sare ko mil mila ke hum log dispatching bolte hain. Okay, so as production moves from project to batch to mass to continuous, what happens? Maine aapko bataya na ki project या job production, this is one of the production system. Then comes batch production system, then comes mass production system, then comes continuous production system, then comes continuous production system, continuous production system. So how this all changes, how this all flows? Project or job production, so this is a single job, single job getting produced. Continuous means many small jobs, many small jobs getting produced. So as the this production system changes, here there is a lot of variety. In the single job, this is basically what you call, there is a term here, I think customized. This is customized, and lot of variety option is there. As per the customer, you will make it. What kind of project do you want? What kind of job do you want? So there can be huge variety. Yahan pe variety minimum hoti hai and customized nahi hota hai. Automatic mode hota hai sare ka sara. So jaise se demand actually increases, as the demand increases, you keep on moving to mass production system. Suppose there is a demand of particular thing, like daily consumables, you know, they are much in demand. So for that, you do not go for project production system or job production system, you go for mass production system or continuous production system. Yes, this is most automated. This side is most automated. Automation is maximum here. Minimum flexibility. Flexibility is minimum here. And yes, huge demand is also there. That is how these systems are different. Okay, what do you mean by group technology? You know, this group technology is nothing but group. This is basically the cellular layout, cellular. So what happens is that you keep different kind of machines in particular group so that any kind of job comes, I can tailor make it, I can introduce some kind of variety into this and I can make it up. That is called basically group technology. So what is group technology? Cellular or group layout. It is basically large variety is permissible in small volumes. Whenever you see volume batch is nothing but a group of products, jobs which I am to produce, is basically combination of process and product layout. Process layout, product layout. What is process layout? This is the process layout, and then other side is product layout. Product layout. Layout means on the production shop you have kept the machines. Layout. आपने किस तरीके से machines को रखा है? Suppose you have kept all the machines as per the product. Machine 1, machine 2, machine 3. So this is mass production system. This is product going on. This is mass production system. This is called mass production system. We have already done line production or mass production system. Line balancing, you know. So one product, after that another product, after that another product. So I have made this all machines as per the product. What I want to focus on is product. So one particular product goes to machine 1, machine 2, machine 3, different kind of machines. That is called line production system, product layout or mass production system. So product layout or mass production system. This said process, what happens is, for particular processes, what process? Let us say this section is only machining. This is machining section. Machining mein bhi maine only lathe machine ko rakha hai. So product of different type can come here. Product 1, 2, 3, all products go here and they are getting the machining, or they are getting the particular process. What process? Machining process. So what I am doing now, I am keeping all the similar kind of machines at one place, and all the different kind of products are coming here. Different kind of products are coming here. So they will get machined, similar machining on these particular products. Yahan pe kya tha? Ek product, sari machines. Yahan ek particular type ki machine, sare product. To isko bolte hain process. Kaun si process? Machining process. So process is fixed. Now suppose I tell you that okay, this entire lane is a barber shop. Yahan pe barbers hi baithe honge sare. So every person will be requiring different kind of cutting, you know, different people requiring different style of cutting, but cutting is the process. So all barbers are sitting there. So ye process layout hai. Kaun si process? Haircut. Wo ek process hai. Different machines, different barbers are sitting there. Similar kind of machines, haircut, barbers are sitting there. And different products, different people requiring different kind of cut, they are going there. Now what is a product layout? Product layout means I am a product. I go to barber shop first, and then I go to some another shop, then I go to some another shop, and mere sare kaam ho gaye. Jo mere ko karne the, mere ko sare kaam kar liye. Ye mass production system, jiske liye aapke paas product layout chahiye. To industry ke andar process layout, product layout hota hai, aur ye group technology jo hai, ye basically in dono ka combination hai. In dono ka combination agar kar dein, to aapke paas cellular लेआउट बन जाता है. नाउ व्हाट इज सेलुलर लेआउट? दैट मींस अ पर्टिकुलर काइंड ऑफ मशीन्स, अ ग्रुप ऑफ मशीन्स आर केप्ट एट वन एंड देन एट द सेकंड प्लेस. दिस इज हाउ दिस एंटायर लेआउट इज फॉर्म्ड. ओके, सो कानबान सिस्टम एज आई टोल्ड यू इज रिलेटेड टू जस्ट इन टाइम. कानबान इज रिलेटेड टू जस्ट इन टाइम. आई डोंट वॉन्ट वेस्टेज, सो आई वॉन्ट मिनिमम इन्वेंट्री. सो कानबान इज रिलेटेड टू फ्लो, बेसिकली फ्लो ऑफ द बेसिकली रॉ मटीरियल और फिनिश्ड प्रोडक्ट, सो दैट बॉटल नेक्स आर मिनिमम. सो आई इशू सम काइंड ऑफ कार्ड्स और जॉब्स और समथिंग एंड आई मेक फैसिलिटेट द प्रॉपर बेसिकली यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ द रिसोर्सेज. सो दिस कंट्रोल्स द लॉजिस्टिक चेन फ्रॉम प्रोडक्शन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. दिस इज नॉट अ इन्वेंट्री कंट्रोल सिस्टम. ये जस्ट इन टाइम नहीं है, लेकिन इट फैसिलिटेट्स द जस्ट इन टाइम. दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इट. यस, जॉनसन्स रूल नाउ इज एप्लीकेबल फॉर टू मशीन्स एंड एन जॉब्स. आई टोल्ड यू वन मशीन एंड जॉब. नाउ देयर इज अ मशीन वन एंड देन मशीन टू. मशीन वन एंड मशीन टू. रिमेंबर देयर आर जॉब्स ए बी सी डी. So all these jobs first will go to machine 1 and then to machine 2. So this is machine 1, this is machine 2. So all the jobs first will go to machine 1 and then these will go to machine 2. Only thing is how you have to hit, how you have to sequence it. That is a Johnson's rule. So Johnson's rule is related to this. Dispatching function of production. So dispatch, abhi humne discuss kiya. डिस्पैच फंक्शन क्या होता है, वी जस्ट डिस्कस. बेसिकली दिस इज नथिंग बट ऑथराइजिंग अ प्रोडक्शन वर्क ऑर्डर टू बी लॉन्च्ड. सो प्रोडक्शन वर्क ऑर्डर को लॉन्च करना इज कॉल्ड डिस्पैचिंग. ओके, विच प्रोडक्शन इज सुटेबल फॉर मेकिंग द नट बोल्ट वॉशर. ये बहुत ज्यादा, दीज आर रिक्वायर्ड इन लार्ज नंबर. लार्ज नंबर, सेम टाइप, नो वेराइटी. हमारे पास वैरायटी थोड़े है इसकी, नो वैरायटी. लार्ज नंबर, सेम टाइप, मास प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम, मास या कंटिन्यूअस प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम. दिस इज मास और कंटिन्यूअस प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम, दैट इज व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड. मास प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम और कंटिन्यूअस प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम, राइट. एंड समबडी आस्क यू, एरोप्लेन कैसे बनता है? एरोप्लेन बनता है जॉब प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम. एरोप्लेन और उनके बीच में क्या हो गया, उनके बीच के अंदर हो गया तुम्हारा बैच प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम, जो एक बैचेस में बनते हैं. बैच प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम, लेट्स से ऑटोमोबाइल, कुछ ऑटोमोबाइल जो एक पर्टिकुलर बैचेस में तुम बनाते हो. कारें, कार बनाओगे एक बैच में. स्पेयर पार्ट्स, मास प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम. ओके, सो पर्ट एंड सीपीएम में, यू नो पर्ट एंड सीपीएम, क्रिटिकल पाथ मेथड, प्रोग्राम इवेल्यूएशन एंड रिव्यू टेक्निक. सो दिस इज डिटर्मिनिस्टिक, डिटर्मिनिस्टिक. दिस इज प्रोबेबिलिस्टिक, प्रोबेबिलिस्टिक. दिस इज बेसिकली फॉर न्यू प्रोजेक्ट्स, न्यू प्रोजेक्ट्स. सो पर्ट एंड सीपीएम क्या होते हैं? दे आर द नेटवर्क टेक्निक्स इन विच you find out the critical path, longest path and shortest time in which project can be completed. PERT is probabilistic model based and this is activity based, this is event based. This is normally used for new projects. Yahan pe aapke paas activity time is known for sure, activity time TIJ is known, but yahan pe TIJ is to be obtained from optimistic time, most likely time, pessimistic time. So these three time estimates are given to us. On the basis of that we find out the basically activity time or expected time of an activity. The formula is this: expected time of any activity in PERT, which eventually will become TIJ. Or ek baar mere paas TIJ aa gaya to fir main network diagram pe critical path nikal sakta hu. So this is the formula: TP plus 4 times TM plus T naught by 6. That way you calculate the expected time of an activity, or which is called TIJ. Similarly, variance is nothing but square of standard deviation, and standard deviation is nothing but TP minus T naught by 6 is called standard deviation. So standard deviation is pessimistic time minus optimistic time over 6. Pessimistic means agar nothing works your way, everything gets delayed, then how much time is to be taken? Optimistic means everything goes okay, then how it is to be done. Okay, so expected time of completion of an activity, we know this is the formula, and variance ka formula ye hai, that we know this is how variance is to be calculated. Now let me tell you, let me give you one diagram here. Let us say we have got three paths. Let's say this is A, this is B, this is C, D, this is E, this is F. And let me make with different color now. Let me choose different color here. Let's say this is the longest path. So what we get is ADF. ADF is the critical path. What do we mean by critical path? Sir, longest path on the network diagram, and this shows the shortest time to complete project. So what is the shortest time to complete the project? That is AD, that is the critical time. Let us say ADF is the critical path. Now suppose I give you, he will give you T optimistic, T pessimistic, T most likely for each activity. From there you will calculate the expected time for each activity in the PERT. Now let us say usne aapko variance de rakha hai iska iska iska. Suppose VA, VD, VF is the variance, of each of the activity on critical path. तो पूरे क्रिटिकल पाथ का मेरे को बताओ वेरिएंस कैसे निकालेंगे, हाउ शैल वी कैलकुलेट दैट, या स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन कैसे निकालेंगे. रिमेंबर दैट स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन इज वेरिएंस अंडर रूट. तो मेरे पास ए का स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन कैसे निकलेगा, वी ए अंडर रूट. डी का स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन कैसे निकलेगा, वी डी अंडर रूट. F का स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन कैसे निकलेगा, वी एफ अंडर रूट, राइट. और मेरे पास पूरा स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन कैसे निकलेगा, क्रिटिकल पाथ का स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन कैसे निकलेगा, वेरिएंस ऑफ A प्लस वेरिएंस ऑफ D प्लस वेरिएंस ऑफ F अंडर रूट इज नथिंग बट स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन A स्क्वेयर प्लस स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन D स्क्वेयर प्लस स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन F स्क्वेयर अंडर रूट. ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. क्रिटिकल पाथ का स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन इज इक्वल टू स्क्वेयर ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन, सम ऑफ स्क्वेयर ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ ईच एक्टिविटी अंडर रूट ऑफ दैट. डू नॉट डू स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ क्रिटिकल पाथ इज सिग्मा ए प्लस सिग्मा डी प्लस सिग्मा एफ. सो दैट मीन्स सिग्मा ऑफ क्रिटिकल पाथ इज नॉट इक्वल टू सिग्मा ए प्लस सिग्मा डी प्लस सिग्मा एफ. ऐसे नहीं निकलेगा, ये गलत है. So if you want to calculate the sigma or standard deviation of critical path, this is the formula you have to use. And from here, very frequently question is asked. What is the main objective of crashing? Decrease cost or decrease project duration? Yeah. So as we know, we have two kind of cost. Agar main time dekhun aur main cost dekhun. तो देयर इज अ डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट, देयर इज अ इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट. क्रैशिंग मींस, लेट मी चूज डिफरेंट कलर नाउ. क्रैशिंग मींस कंप्रेसिंग, कंप्रेसिंग मींस रिड्यूसिंग द टाइम ऑफ कंप्लीशन ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट, टाइम ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट. प्रेजेंटली हाउ मच टाइम प्रोजेक्ट इज टेकिंग टू कंप्लीट, that is calculated through critical path, that is the time taken. I want to complete it even lesser time, then I need to compress it or crash it. So when you crash it, time to kam hoga, that means you are moving this side. So if I add these two, this is the total cost, crashing means this. So there will be a time at which you will get optimum time of completion of project. Optimum time is minimum cost. Minimum cost ke upar. लेकिन जब तुम क्रैश करते हो तो क्या होता है, डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट बढ़ती है, दिस इज डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट, दिस इज इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट। इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट, इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट मीन्स जैसे रेंट, डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट मीन्स मटेरियल कॉस्ट, ये हम पहले डिस्कस कर चुके हैं, मटेरियल कॉस्ट। सो क्या होता है, क्रैशिंग में टाइम इज ऑलवेज डिक्रीजिंग। समबडी आस्क यू व्हाट हैपेंस टू द कॉस्ट इन क्रैशिंग, कॉस्ट मे इंक्रीज, इट मे डिक्रीज और इट मे रिमेन सेम। एंड व्हाट अबाउट टाइम, टाइम ऑलवेज डिक्रीजेस। डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट पे क्या फर्क पड़ता है सर, डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट तो आपकी बढ़ जाती है, और इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट पे क्या फर्क पड़ता है, इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट आपकी कम हो जाती है, और क्योंकि दोनों अपोजिट हैं इसलिए टोटल कॉस्ट कैन इंक्रीज और इट कैन डिक्रीज ऑल्सो। ओके, अर्लीएस्ट फिनिश टाइम, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट, देयर आर फोर टाइम्स अर्लीएस्ट स्टार्ट टाइम, दिस इज अर्लीएस्ट स्टार्ट टाइम ऑफ एन एक्टिविटी, लेटेस्ट फिनिश टाइम, लेटेस्ट फिनिश टाइम ऑफ एन एक्टिविटी, देन कम्स अर्लीएस्ट फिनिश टाइम, देन कम्स अर्लीएस्ट फिनिश टाइम। अर्लीएस्ट फिनिश टाइम, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अर्लीएस्ट फिनिश टाइम सर, दैट इज अर्लीएस्ट स्टार्ट टाइम प्लस एक्टिविटी टाइम, टी आई जे इज एक्टिविटी टाइम। लेटेस्ट स्टार्ट टाइम, लेटेस्ट फिनिश टाइम माइनस टी आई जे। सो ये चार टाइम एस्टिमेट्स यूज होते हैं पर्ट एंड सीपीएम नेटवर्क डायग्राम के ऊपर। यू मे बी इन पोजिशन टू स्टार्ट योर जॉब एज अर्ली एज पॉसिबल टूडे इटसेल्फ। मैं ज्यादा से ज्यादा कितना टाइम लगा सकता हूं सर, लेट मी गिव यू दिस एक्टिविटी ए, बिटवीन इवेंट वन एंड टू, एंड टाइम टेकन फॉर दिस इज 2 days। ओके सर, अर्लीएस्ट मैं कब से स्टार्ट कर सकता हूं, 0 day, आज ही स्टार्ट कर दो यार, क्या ट्रबल है, 0 day पे स्टार्ट कर दो। अच्छा, अर्लीएस्ट फिनिश कब कर सकता हूं, अर्लीएस्ट फिनिश कब कर सकता हूं, 2 दिन में खत्म कर दो उसको यार, क्या ट्रबल है। सर लेटेस्ट फिनिश कब कर सकता हूं, 5 दिन के अंदर, आपने कैलकुलेशन मारा और 5 दिन मैक्सिमम तुम कर सकते हो। अच्छा सर, तो लेटेस्ट स्टार्ट कब कर सकता हूं, लेटेस्ट स्टार्ट कब कर सकता हूं, 5 दिन तुम्हारे पास है मैक्सिमम, 2 दिन तो काम करने को लगेगा, तो 3 दिन पे भी स्टार्ट करोगे तो हो जाएगा। दोबारा समझो ध्यान से, सर मैं इस काम को अर्लीस्ट स्टार्ट कब कर सकता हूं, अभी कर दो। तो यहां पे इस एक्टिविटी को आई बोलते हैं, इसको जे बोलते हैं, सॉरी इवेंट को आई एंड जे बोलते हैं, ई आई एल आई, ई जे एल जे। सो ये आई होता है, ये जे होता है, इस एक्टिविटी के लिए ई आई ऐसे निकालते हैं और एल जे ये होता है। फॉर एनी एक्टिविटी अर्लीस्ट स्टार्ट टाइम इज टू बी सीन ऑन इनिशियल इवेंट, फॉर एनी एक्टिविटी लेटेस्ट फिनिश टाइम इज टू बी सीन ऑन द एंड इवेंट, ई आई एल जे, ई आई एल जे। अर्लीएस्ट फिनिश टाइम इज ई आई प्लस टी आई जे, सो दिस वन इज ई आई, दिस वन इज एल जे, ई आई प्लस टी आई जे, एल जे माइनस टी आई जे, दैट इज हाउ यू कैलकुलेट फॉर डिफरेंट एक्टिविटीज। ओके, आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस। क्रिटिकल पाथ इज व्हाट, मैक्सिमम रिसोर्स आर यूज, नो, मिनिमम रिसोर्स आर यूज, नो, वेयर डिले इज नॉट, सो व्हाट इज द क्रिटिकल पाथ नाउ, समबडी आस्क यू व्हाट इज क्रिटिकल पाथ सर ऑन पर्ट एंड सीपीएम, डू यू कैलकुलेट क्रिटिकल पाथ ऑन सीपीएम और यू कैलकुलेट इट ऑन पर्ट ऑल्सो, सर वी कैलकुलेट इट ऑन बोथ पर्ट एज वेल एज सीपीएम, हम दोनों पे निकालते हैं इसको। व्हाट इज दिस पाथ सर, लॉन्गेस्ट पाथ, लॉन्गेस्ट पाथ ऑन नेटवर्क डायग्राम,
longest path on network diagram. Okay, this is the shortest time of completion of project. Completion of project. This is the shortest time in which you can think of completing the project. Done. If any activity on it is delayed, entire project gets delayed by same time. So that is very, very important, same time. Suppose some activity on critical path, which is called critical activity, gets delayed by one day. Entire project gets delayed by one day. That is what you have to understand. Then no float, we saw different kind of float on activities, or slack, permissible, permitted on critical activity. So slack on event is zero and float on activity is also zero. Right? So this is how this critical path is understood. Why it is called critical? Because all the activities are very critical, because if they are not completed in time, then entire project may get delayed. Can I complete the project less than critical time? Yes, that is called compressing. But for compressing to take place, it should be technically feasible and economically viable. Technically feasible hona chahiye, economically to chalo kharcha bad gaya, lekin technically feasible hona chahiye. Okay, so kya de rakha hai hamare paas? Standard deviation of the jobs are given. Bolta hai A, D, H, I are critical jobs. To mere paas de ke rakha hai, standard deviation de rakha hai. A is critical activity, D is critical activity, H is critical activity, I is critical activity. एक और कॉलम बना लेते हैं वेरिएंस का. कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द वेरिएंस ऑफ ए? सिग्मा ऑफ ए का स्क्वायर, दैट इज वन. वेरिएंस ऑफ डी, वेरिएंस ऑफ डी इज सिग्मा ऑफ डी स्क्वायर, दैट इज वन. वेरिएंस ऑफ एच, सिग्मा ऑफ एच का स्क्वायर वन. वेरिएंस ऑफ आई, सिग्मा ऑफ आई का स्क्वायर, दैट इज वन. अभी मेरे को बताओ क्रिटिकल पाथ पे टोटल वेरिएंस कितना है, ऐड कर दो. 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 कितना हो गया, टोटल 4. अब क्रिटिकल पाथ पे स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन कितना है? क्रिटिकल पाथ पे स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन है वेरिएंस का अंडर रूट. सो दैट इज व्हाट वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड. सो यू रिमेंबर दैट स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ क्रिटिकल पाथ इज स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ ईच एक्टिविटी ऑन क्रिटिकल पाथ, उसका स्क्वायर एंड अंडर रूट. वो आपको याद रखना है. बेसिकली वेरिएंस से इसको निकालो. CPM is activity oriented. Yes, that is true. When activity times are deterministic, that is also true. Is a planning device, that is also true. CPM is not. Basically, you see, ये दोनों आपस में contradictory हैं. ये दोनों आपस में contradictory हैं. CPM नहीं, यहाँ पे PERT होना चाहिए था. PERT deterministic होता है, right? PERT जो event oriented होता है, probabilistic है. Directly introduces cost concept analysis. ये क्या चीज है? D is wrong. Revise this. CPM is activity based, PERT is event deterministic, probabilistic. 3 time estimate लगते हैं इसमें. इसमें only deterministic time estimate होता है. Planning devices, ये planning device है, PERT control device है. ये थोड़ा सा important point है. दोनों वैसे तो planning में use करते हैं. Project planning and control. दोनों डिवाइसेस हैं. बेसिकली प्लानिंग एंड कंट्रोल, थोड़ा सा माइन्यूट डिफरेंस है. माइन्यूट डिफरेंस. तो सीपीएम प्लानिंग एक्टिविटी है. प्लान तुम तभी कर पाओगे अगर डिटर्मिनिस्टिक चीजें दिमाग में हैं. यू नो दैट दिस इज हाउ इट इज गोइंग, सो आई कैन मेक द प्लान ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ रियलिस्टिक डाटा विद मी, डिटर्मिनिस्टिक डाटा विद मी. कंट्रोल डिवाइस मीन्स बीच में कुछ चेंज आ गया तो आई नीड टू चेंज दैट. It is called the control device. So control means बीच में अगर मेरे को कुछ change आ गया, how I am to do that? It is called control device. ओके नाउ दिस आई थिंक वी ऑलरेडी नो कैसे इसको निकालना है. ऑप्टिमिस्टिक टाइम, मोस्ट लाइकली टाइम, फोर टाइम्स मोर मोस्ट लाइकली टाइम, दिस फॉर्मूला आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन यू. एक्सपेक्टेड टाइम हम ऐसे निकालते हैं. सिक्स सिग्मा मीन्स व्हाट? देखो सिक्स सिग्मा जो है ना, सिक्स सिग्मा इज जीरो डिफेक्ट बेसिकली, मीनिंग नो डिफेक्ट, जीरो डिफेक्ट. 3.1 डिफेक्ट्स पर मिलियन, यस 3.1 डिफेक्ट्स पर मिलियन. लेट मी सी वेदर दिस इज करेक्ट. 3.4 मिलियंस, आई थिंक दिस इज 3.4 मिलियंस डिफेक्ट्स पर मिलियन अपॉर्चुनिटी, डिफेक्ट्स पर मिलियन अपॉर्चुनिटी. सो डेटा इज 3.4 मिलियन होता है 10 लाख, 1 मिलियन इज 10 लाख. तो 10 लाख प्रोडक्ट में से 3 से 4 प्रोडक्ट डिफेक्टेड हैं, ऑलमोस्ट नो डिफेक्ट, जीरो डिफेक्ट. जैसे जस्ट इन टाइम इज जीरो इन्वेंट्री, सिक्स सिग्मा इज जीरो डिफेक्ट. और इसका मीनिंग होता है 99.9997% ऑफ द एरिया. सिग्मा इज स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन. स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन मीन्स बेसिकली मीन से कितना डेविएशन. तो 6 - 6 टोटल डेविएशन, टोटल एरिया अंडर दैट इज 99.9997%. दैट इज द डेटा एक्चुअली यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. उसके बियॉन्ड बहुत ही कम बचता है. बियॉन्ड दैट डेविएशन वेरी लेस इज लेफ्ट. सो आउट ऑफ 1 मिलियन ओनली 3.4 आइटम्स आर लेफ्ट आउट ऑफ दैट रेंज. द रेस्ट इज एक्सेप्टेबल रेंज. रेस्ट कम्स विद इन acceptable range. Critical activity has zero slack, no doubt about that, it has zero slack. We have already discussed what is the critical activity. Okay, find the latest start time for activity D. Everything is given. I hope you know how to make it. So earliest start time, latest finish time is to be calculated for each of the activity. लेट्स अज्यूम इनिशियल इवेंट के लिए जीरो. अज्यूम क्या होता ही जीरो है. तो वट इज ई अर्लीस्ट स्टार्ट टाइम, वट इज एल लेटेस्ट फिनिश टाइम. देर इज ओनली वन वे टू रीच हेयर, सो आई राइट इट 5. ई एल. नाउ हाउ मेनी वेज आर देयर टू रीच इवेंट 3? 2. यहां से जाऊंगा तो 5, यहां से जाऊंगा तो 10. और क्योंकि 3 जो है वो क्रिटिकल पाथ पे है, कॉमन पाथ पे है, तो ये एल भी 10 रहेगा. एनी हाउ यहां पर आ गया अगर तो 10 + 5 = 15. अब मेरे को बताओ यहां तक पहुंचने के कितने रास्ते हैं. 10 + 5 = 15, 15 + 5 = 20. दिस इज ऑल्सो 20. 20 - 5, एल इज 15. 20 - 5, नाउ 15 - 5 = 10. सो आई एम गोइंग फ्रॉम हेयर एंड देन आई एम गोइंग फ्रॉम हेयर. दिस इज अ क्रिटिकल पाथ, राइट? दिस इज अ क्रिटिकल पाथ. नो लेटेस्ट स्टार्ट टाइम फॉर एक्टिविटी डी. नो लेट मी मेक एक्टिविटी डी. Activity D. What is activity time for D? 5 days. 3-4. What is E and L? What is E and L? And remember that this is I, this is J. Right? So what is for 3? 10-10. And this is 20-20. So what is relevant for us is this E and this L. So earliest start time for activity D is 10 days. Earliest finish time for activity D. Suppose somebody asks me to calculate the earliest finish time for activity D, earliest start time plus 5, 15 days. Latest finish time, 20 days. Latest start time, 20 - 5 = 15 days. Latest start. So what is latest finish time? 20 - 5 = 15 days. That is how you have to calculate it. Right? So I hope this is clear to you. This is how we have to go for it. What is the dummy activities are doing in network diagram? What dummy activities are doing on network diagram? They are precedence relationship. So dummy activities ka do kaam hota hai. So dummy activities डमी एक्टिविटीज आर बेसिकली घोस्ट एक्टिविटीज, दीज आर घोस्ट एक्टिविटीज, नॉट रियल, दे आर नॉट रियल एक्टिविटीज. सो व्हाई दे आर देयर? टू प्रिवेंट डुप्लीकेशन एक्टिविटीज, टू प्रिवेंट डुप्लीकेट एक्टिविटीज. डुप्लीकेट एक्टिविटीज कैन नॉट एग्जिस्ट. व्हाट आर द डुप्लीकेट एक्टिविटीज? सर, इफ द स्टार्टिंग एंड एंड इवेंट इज द सेम, देन सच एक्टिविटीज ए बी सी आर बिटवीन वन एंड टू, ए बी सी आर डुप्लीकेट एक्टिविटीज. Duplicate activities cannot exist on the network diagram because they've got no meaning. Duplicate activities cannot exist. So dummy activity ka ek kaam hai duplicate activity ko prevent karna. Number two, to establish precedence relation. Precedence relationship. So we can establish the precedence relationship. Okay, after this, this will happen and then this will happen. That is called precedence relationship. And understand one thing, these consume no resource. Consume no time or no resource. Koi bhi resource consume nahi karti hain ye activities. So these activities which are basically the dummy activities, these consume no resource. I think expected time we have already calculated. This is the formula. Not correct. You can find this also. I am moving little fast. It is event oriented. CPM is activity oriented. Ye humne kar liya. Yes. Use of CPM is in planning and controlling. The most logical sequence of operation. Morgan Walker, remember this, critical path method was used first time by him. Detailed planning was possible, scheduling was possible. Standard method was found out how to do it. That is what is the basically advantage of this. किस लिए यूज करते हैं इसको? व्हाट इज द मेन पर्पज ऑफ दैट? एग्जीक्यूटिंग अ प्रोजेक्ट. डोंट फाइंड न्यू प्रोजेक्ट के लिए तो पर्ट यूज करते हैं, लेकिन जो चॉइसेस हमें दे रखी थी, इन द चॉइसेस बेस्ट इज एक्चुअली प्रोजेक्ट. प्रोजेक्ट नेटवर्क टेक्निक्स, दीज आर प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट टूल्स एंड दीज आर द नेटवर्क डायग्राम्स. These are network diagrams. These are the network diagrams and project management tools. Okay, now there is something which is called cash crash cost slope. As I told you, crashing or compressing is to reduce the time of the entire project. When you crash or compress the network diagram, you should compress or crash that activity which has minimum cost slope. Cost slope means the money spent in compressing per activity by per day should be minimum. Obviously, that is called cash. So, let me tell you what is this. Let's say indirect cost. I told you, this is the cost, this is the time. Normally, this is the normal. Let's say this is the crash point. Normal time, crash time, crash cost, normal cost. Crashing, you are going from N to C. If you are doing your job at the normal time, this is the time taken, this is the cost. Cost and time taken. So, let me rewrite this. This is normal cost. I assume it to be straight line. I assume it to be straight line. And then what is the slope? I'll say this is the crashing cost minus normal cost over normal time minus crash time. This is the cost slope. यू अंडरस्टैंड. नाउ यू शुड क्रैश दैट एक्टिविटी फर्स्ट विच हैज मिनिमम स्लोप, विच हैज मिनिमम कॉस्ट स्लोप. सो व्हेन देयर इज अ इनडायरेक्ट, दिस इज द सॉरी डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट. डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट विल इंक्रीज ऑन क्रैशिंग, इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट विल डिक्रीज ऑन क्रैशिंग. सो इफ आई टेक द डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट एंड आई क्रैश दैट पर्टिकुलर एक्टिविटी, कॉस्ट विल इंक्रीज, टाइम विल बी डिक्रीजिंग. सो कॉस्ट विल इंक्रीज टू सी सी एंड नॉर्मल कॉस्ट इज सी एन, टाइम विल डिक्रीज टू टी सी एंड नॉर्मल टाइम इज टी एन. दिस इज हाउ इट इज टू बी कैलकुलेटेड. या सो सिंप्लेक्स मेथड इज ऑपरेशन मैनेजमेंट का बेसिक मेथड, ऑपरेशन रिसर्च का. ऑपरेशन रिसर्च का सिंप्लेक्स मेथड इज ग्राफिकल मेथड, वन इज कॉल्ड ग्राफिकल मेथड, अनदर इज कॉल्ड सिंप्लेक्स मेथड. ग्राफिकल मेथड एंड सिंप्लेक्स मेथड, आई एम श्योर यू पीपल हैव ऑलरेडी डन दीज मेथड्स. यू नो ग्राफिकल मेथड फॉर टू वेरिएबल्स, दे आर फॉर टू वेरिएबल्स एंड देर इज नो सच लिमिट ऑन द सिंप्लेक्स मेथड. सो सिंप्लेक्स मेथड वर्क्स ऑन वन बेसिकली एल्गोरिदम एंड दीज आर मेथड्स टू सॉल्व लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम. सो लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम्स कैन बी सॉल्व यूजिंग दीज मेथड्स. नाउ व्हाट इज लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग? इट ऑप्टिमाइजेस लीनियर ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन अंडर लिमिटेड कंस्ट्रेंट्स. सो बी इज द आंसर. व्हेन वी से लीनियर ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन एंड देर आर कंस्ट्रेंट्स, ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन 2x प्लस 3y, x एंड y आर लीनियर बेसिकली फंक्शंस वेरिएबल एंड z इज ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन विच इज फंक्शन बेसिकली लीनियर ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन बिकॉज x एंड y आर नॉट हैविंग एनी पावर्स, दे आर फर्स्ट ऑर्डर बेसिकली वेरिएबल्स. सो लेट से x एंड y आर एनी वेरिएबल एंड z इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन एंड देर आर कंस्ट्रेंट्स. सो टिपिकल बेसिकली स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम इज देर इज ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन एंड देन देर आर कंस्ट्रेंट्स. सो somebody ask यू what इज द लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम, टिपिकली यू कैन राइट, विल से सर ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन z इज, यू हैव टू इधर मैक्सिमाइज इट और यू हैव टू मिनिमाइज इट एंड देर आर सम रिसोर्स कंस्ट्रेंट्स. x प्लस y इज लेस देन इक्वल टू 10, 2x प्लस y इज लेस देन इक्वल टू 15, वेयर x एंड y आर ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 0. दिस इज अ टिपिकल लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम. नाउ दीज आर कॉल्ड रिसोर्स कंस्ट्रेंट्स. रिसोर्स कंस्ट्रेंट्स, यू नो resources are limited. If resources are unlimited, I need not to even go for linear programming problem because then it is automatically done. So resources are limited. Number two, these are called non-negativity constraints. They are called non-negativity constraints. So we have negative constraints and we have non-negativity constraints. Right, this is how these two things are there. What is Hungarian algorithm? Any idea about that? Where Hungarian algorithm is used? Assignment problem, you know, assignment, transportation and assignment mein, assignment, one to one. Transportation is not one to one. Transportation can be a matrix of 3 to 4 matrix or something like that, demand and supply points. But assignment mein, one machine, one operator, one to one. This is assignment problem. Northwest corner rule gives the initial basic feasible solution. Northwest corner rule is basically allocation ka method hai ek, aur aap isko use karte hain northwest corner rule ko, and this is one of the initial feasible solution ko find out karne ka tarika. They are called constraints. The restrictions, as I told you, resources are limited and these are called constraints. Okay, non-basic variable हुज प्रॉफिट सी जे इज जीरो इन ऑप्टिमल टेबल, नॉन बेसिक वेरिएबल विद जीरो इन द ऑप्टिमल सॉल्यूशन. सो इफ यू गो टू सिंपलेक्स टेबल, इफ यू गो टू सिंपलेक्स टेबल, ही विल आस्क यू दैट हाउ डू यू नो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सिंपलेक्स टेबल दैट दिस लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम इज इनफिजिबल और इट इज हैविंग मल्टीपल ऑप्टिमल सॉल्यूशन और इट इज डीजनरेट. दीज आर सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस विल बी आस्क्ड. मल्टीपल ऑप्टिमल सॉल्यूशन एंड अनबाउंड. मल्टीपल ऑप्टिमल सॉल्यूशन मींस द नॉन बेसिक डिसीजन वेरिएबल, नॉन बेसिक डिसीजन वेरिएबल इफ दे गेट जीरो इन नेट इवेल्यूशन रो. लेट मी टेल यू दैट व्हेन द ऑप्टिमल सिंप्लेक्स टेबल इज अटेंड, यू नो यू गेट मेनी सिंप्लेक्स टेबल इन द सिंप्लेक्स method you will get many iterations, there are many tables, at the end you will reach a table which is optimum table. How do you see optimum table? That you know, in that optimum table let us say x, y, z are decision variable, they were decision variable. You know what is decision variable? Decision variables are the variables which are part of your problem in terms of which you defined the objective function. For example, you say maximize z is equal to 2x plus 3y plus z. So x, y, z are decision variable. Now in cj column, in cj column x, y is there but z is not there, some another slack variable is there, let us say, and net evaluation row mein इसका वैल्यू जो आपका z आया यहां पे नॉन बेसिक डिसीजन वेरिएबल, z का वैल्यू यहां पे जीरो आ जाए. नाउ दिस z इज नॉन बेसिक डिसीजन वेरिएबल, दिस इज द बेसिक डिसीजन वेरिएबल, दिस इज बेसिक डिसीजन वेरिएबल. व्हाई बेसिक डिसीजन वेरिएबल? बिकॉज इट इज अपियरिंग इन द बेसिस कॉलम. लेट्स राइट दिस कॉलम एज बेसिस कॉलम, बेसिस कॉलम. So you go to simplex table, optimum simplex table, under basis column you will find some decision variable. We are talking about that decision variable which is not here. Out of all the decision variables, the variable which is not there, that is called non-basic decision variable. If in the net evaluation row the value of that non-basic decision variable is zero, then you get multiple optimal solution or alternate optimal solution. That is the meaning of it. That is what he is asking. So on the basis of simplex table also some questions can be asked. Primal and dual, you know what is the meaning of primal? Primal is when you write the linear programming problem first time. Dual is its transpose, another way to write it. So the number of constraints of primal become number of variable in primal. So whatever variable, decision variable you have here, they become number of constraints here. Whatever number of constraints you get here, whatever number of constraints you get here, they become variable in dual. So primal, dual, dual, primal, transpose hote hain ek dusre ka, that you know what is the meaning of that. Yes. How many variables you can solve graphically? I told you two. Up to two variables are there, you can solve that graphically. Objective function. How shall you calculate the objective function? Objective function is given as 3x plus 9y and these are the constraints. Just graphically, solve it graphically. So you make the equations and see the common feasible region. Common feasible region. You know these are not equations, these are inequalities. These are inequalities. Jaise x, this is 8, this is 8. Now x plus y is less than equal to 8. Just put value 0. Origin. Origin pe x or y ka value kitna hai? 0 hai. Is origin satisfied by this? Yes, 0 plus 0 is less than 8. Yes, satisfied. That means feasible region is this side. सिमिलरली दूसरे का भी फिजिबल रीजन यहां है, नॉन नेगेटिविटी कंस्ट्रेंट्स ये है, तो एक कॉमन फिजिबल रीजन है। कॉमन फिजिबल रीजन के तीन कॉर्नर हैं और उन तीन कॉर्नर में से किसी एक के ऊपर मैक्सिमाइजेशन, अगर प्रॉब्लम मैक्सिमाइजेशन का है, आई थिंक इसने मैक्सिमाइजेशन का ही प्रॉब्लम दिया, तो मैक्सिमाइजेशन का प्रॉब्लम है तो कैलकुलेट करो और तुम्हें पता लग जाएगा, ग्राफिकल मेथड एवरीबॉडी नोज। सो एग्जाम में ग्राफिकल मेथड में से क्वेश्चन आ सकता है। ये चारों मेथड हमने किए हैं एंड वोगल गिव्स बेस्ट सॉल्यूशन टू स्टार्ट विद, बेस्ट सॉल्यूशन टू स्टार्ट विद, नॉट द ऑप्टिमम सॉल्यूशन, नॉट द ऑप्टिमम सॉल्यूशन। रिमेंबर ऑप्टिमम सॉल्यूशन के लिए तुम्हें ऑप्टिमेलिटी टेस्ट लगाना पड़ता है, जो बिग एम मेथड वगैरह यूज कर सकते हो तुम। सो दिस इज वोगल अप्रोक्सीमेशन मेथड इज बेस्ड अपॉन अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट, अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट ये उसके ऊपर बेस्ड है वोगल अप्रोक्सीमेशन मेथड। इट गिव्स यू द बेस्ट सॉल्यूशन टू स्टार्ट, इनिशियल बेसिक फिजिबल सॉल्यूशन, बेस्ट, बेटर देन नॉर्थ वेस्ट कॉर्नर लीस्ट कॉस्ट मेथड, बट इट इज नॉट द बेस्ट मेथड। सो यू कांट से इट इज द ऑप्टिमम सॉल्यूशन, बट यस इट इज द बेस्ट सॉल्यूशन टू स्टार्ट विद, दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इट। राइट, ओके, विच वन आर करेक्ट, दीज आर द स्टेप्स, आइडेंटिफाई द डिसीजन वेरिएबल्स, राइट ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन, मेंशन द कंस्ट्रेंट्स, नॉन नेगेटिविटी रिस्ट्रिक्शंस आर ऑल्सो टू बी मेंशन, एंड दे ऑल आर लीनियर फंक्शन। सो लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम है, दे ऑल आर लीनियर फंक्शंस। अगेन द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन, रिवाइज दिस ऑल्सो, for solutions of linear programming problem with mixed constraints, big M method, big M method is nothing but big penalty method, basically very big number M is given, to basically ye aapka simplex method mein big M method is used to find out infeasible solution, whenever artificial variable leave the column it is permanently removed from there, so big M method infeasible solution, artificial variable ke sath related hai, artificial variable, you know you have got three kind of variable in linear programming problem, slack variables, surplus variables and artificial variables. Now this surplus and artificial variables, they appear together. ये दोनों variables इकट्ठे होते हैं, artificial and surplus इकट्ठे ही आते हैं. Graphical solution of maximization problem, isoprofit line बोलते हैं इसको, maximization problem. जैसे अगर मैं graph plot करने लगूं, मैक्सिमम जेड इज इक्वल टू 2x + 3y, सब्जेक्ट टू x + y < 10, 2x + y < 15, x, y > 0, सॉल्व इट। सो 2x + 3y = 0 is called isoprofit line. What is the significance of that? You keep moving this line away. Let's say this is the common feasible region for me. Let's say this is the common feasible region on the basis of the constraints which I got. Let us say, मैंने ऐसे constraints बनाई और उससे मेरे पास ये common feasible region बना. तो iso cost line को keep moving away from the origin. Wherever this cuts the common feasible region at the last, that give me optimum solution. That is the meaning of it. Isoprofit line is moved parallel to initial objective line. Corner point of the feasible region, right? So that is where it should cut it. यस डी जनरेसी, आई मीन सेम काइंड ऑफ सोल्यूशन इज पॉपिंग अप एंड वी आर नॉट इंप्रूविंग द सोल्यूशन, सोल्यूशन इंप्रूवमेंट इज नॉट देयर, सोल्यूशन नॉट इंप्रूविंग दैट इज कॉल्ड डी जनरेसिंग. इफ सोल्यूशन इज नॉट इंप्रूविंग दैट इज कॉल्ड डी जनरेसी. कब आता है ये एम रोज एन कॉलम्स डी जनरेसी कब आता है? रिमेंबर इट, एम प्लस एन माइनस वन से अगर नंबर ऑफ एलोकेशंस इन द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन प्रॉब्लम इज लेस देन एम प्लस एन माइनस वन देन द डी जनरेसी अपियर्स. थ्री प्लांट फाइव वेयर हाउसेस, एलोकेशन कितना होना चाहिए? थ्री प्लस फाइव एट, माइनस वन सेवन. अगर उससे कम हो जाएगा तो डी जनरेसी हो जाएगी, उससे कम हो जाएगा तो डी जनरेसी हो जाएगी. मोदी मेथड, हमारे प्राइम मिनिस्टर के नाम से लगा है मोदी मेथड. कहां यूज करते हैं मोदी मेथड? मोदी मेथड इज यूज्ड इन द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन प्रॉब्लम्स. सो दिस मोदी मेथड विल बी यूज्ड इन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन प्रॉब्लम्स. वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन, आई थिंक वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन. कंस्ट्रेंट्स आर गिवन एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन इज ऑल्सो गिवन. कॉमन फिजिबल रीजन आपका ऐसे निकलेगा. Why I am doing this question? Because in HPCL exam, this question can come. Graphical method can come. वो आपको solution करने के लिए ज़्यादा नहीं है, लेकिन graphical method can come. So just revise how it is to be done. What do you mean by feasible solution? Initial feasible solution or feasible solution? What do you mean by feasible solution? What do you mean by that? Constraint should be satisfied. What is the feasible solution? Must satisfy all the problem constraints and non-negativity constraints also. Non-negativity constraints, x plus y, xy should be greater than equal to 0. That is called non-negativity constraints. They should also be satisfied. Variables which have not been assigned the zero value during iterations are called what? Basic variables, initial feasible solution को है. There are two kind of variable, decision variable, जो आपके question के अंदर होते हैं, decision variable, x, y, etc. Basic variables, slack variables, s1, s2, let us say. Initial basic feasible solution में x, y डिसीजन वेरिएबल का वैल्यू जीरो होता है, s1 20, s2 10 एटसेट्रा. सो बेसिक वेरिएबल का वैल्यू जीरो नहीं होता. अगर जीरो हो जाए तो आपके पास डी जनरेसी का चांस बनता है, देन यू गेट द चांस ऑफ डी जनरेसी. 6/6 m प्लस n माइनस वन, सेम क्वेश्चन वी हैव डन. Redundant constraints means additional, not required, that is called additional. It will have no effect on the solution. This is called redundant constraints, means no effect on the solution. M source and destination, basic feasible solution, M plus N minus 1 याद रखना. So very common question. Linear programming problem इस तरीके से formulate करनी है आपको. 100, you see the question, number of units of A and number of units of B produced. Bolta ki let number of units produced of A, let A units, B units produced. So let us say we produce the units A and B, 100 rupaya aur 80 rupaya profit hai. So total profit kitna hai? 100 A plus 80 B, ye profit hai. A and B का 5 hours and 3 hours respectively production time अवेलेबल इज 180, ये देखो 5a 3b has to be less than 180. दूसरा कंस्ट्रेंट क्या है, टोटल बैच 50 ही होना चाहिए, a प्लस बी शुड बी लेस देन ये. अब इसके बेस पे बना लो तो आपके पास सॉल्यूशन इसका बन जाएगा. दैट इज हाउ इट इज टू बी डन. ओनली कॉर्नर पॉइंट्स ऑफ द फिजिबल सॉल्यूशन, कॉर्नर पॉइंट्स के ऊपर सॉल्यूशन मिलता है. सिंप्लेक्स टेबल में सॉल्यूशन जंप्स फ्रॉम वन कॉर्नर टू अनदर, इट कीप्स ऑन जंपिंग फ्रॉम कॉर्नर टू कॉर्नर, एंड दैट इज हाउ यू अटेन द फाइनल सॉल्यूशन. दिस वी हैव डन. डी इज नॉट अ मेथड, डायनेमिक मेथड नहीं है. वोगल अप्रोक्सीमेशन इज बेस्ट टू स्टार्ट विद. लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन लाइन इज कॉल्ड आइसोप्रॉफिट लाइन. इफ आइसोप्रॉफिट लाइन इज पैरेलल टू वन ऑफ द कंस्ट्रेंट्स, देन देर इज अ चांस, नॉट ऑलवेज बट देर इज अ चांस ऑफ मल्टीपल ऑप्टिमल सॉल्यूशन. मे बी, नॉट ऑलवेज, इट मे बी, दैट इज यू हैव टू चेक इट. ये ध्यान से देख लेना. What is a shadow price? Remember it. Value assigned to a unit capacity. उसको बोलते हैं shadow price. Okay, so remember that R is not true. Best among all. Not the optimum, not the optimum one. Remember that. Most optimum नहीं है, best हो सकता है to start with, not the optimum one. And this is not true. It does not give allocations. Does not give allocations. It just tell you how allocation is to be given, but not allocation. Quality control के साथ किसका नाम जुड़ा है? Deming is supposed to be father of quality control. So Deming is supposed to be father of quality control. You should know that the name of Deming is associated with quality control. So I think in HPCL exam some questions from quality control can also be asked. Revise these questions also. Some questions can be asked. Ye jitna bhi hamara micro module chal raha HPCL ka, keep revising it. It is very very effective. The kind of questions we are expecting, directly questions can come from there. So just revise it so that you get some feel of that.